Well, it might be America's most beautiful city. We're in San Diego, and it is indeed a spectacular night inside Qualcomm Stadium for this matchup in the Mountain West Conference. 17th-ranked and undefeated Fresno State playing on homecoming against the Aztecs of San Diego State. Tim DeRuiter, the head coach of the Bulldogs, 15-4 in his second year, and he's got a team that has a chance to qualify for a BCS bowl game. This is a big hurdle here tonight. DeRuiter and his Bulldogs playing on the road against Rocky Long, the head coach of San Diego State. He has done an excellent job his third year here in San Diego with this program. He's the all-time leading winner as a head coach in the history of the Mountain West Conference. The challenge for the Aztecs in large part to slow down Derek Carr, the fifth-year senior quarterback, one of the very best quarterbacks in the country. Carr and the Bulldogs undefeated with big dreams for the way this 2013 season will end. And this could be their toughest test before the finish of the regular season. Dave Fleming alongside David Diaz Infante and Allison Williams. We're happy to have you with us here for this college football matchup in the Mountain West. We expect a lot of points. But, David, two teams that do have very different styles.
Yeah, they certainly do. You think of Fresno State and their BCS busting aspirations. Really one of the better stories in college football this season. What they've been able to do, big, exciting wins, close wins, high-flying offense, and Derek Carr is leading that show. Then you look at San Diego State, the Aztecs, they're going to pound the rock. They're going to line up in two backs and a tight end, take big shots down the field, kind of contrarian approach to offense these days. But I tell you what, Rocky Long has built this thing on defense. They've got a chance here tonight to see if they can stop this high-powered offense.
San Diego State started the year slowly. They've been playing much better lately, plus coming off a bye week, a little extra time to prepare for the undefeated Bulldogs. San Diego State won the kick. They elect to receive and a fair catch on the short kickoff. The Aztecs are going to start over right around their own 25-yard line. And there is their quarterback, the junior. He's a walk-on, Quinn Kaler. He's become a great story for San Diego State.
He certainly has. And Coach talked about, and they don't mean this in a negative way, but he's a game manager. He is growing into the position. He's a walk-on quarterback. He's taking care of the football, he's accurate, and he knows what to do. He's getting him in the right place at the line of scrimmage, and that's what they need him to do. Look, it starts with running the football for them, and then his willingness to be able to take shots down the field and make completions and move the sticks.
Well, Tim DeRuiter, I think right away he's upset, and I think he's got a point with the spot after the catch on the kickoff. But the Aztecs will start on the 25-yard line, and Kaler under center. This ground-oriented. They do have some playmakers in the passing game, though, and Kaler has done a nice job these last few weeks. It'll be San Diego State with the ball first here as this game gets started. And their tailback, the junior Adam Muema, who was hurt at the beginning of the year, he's getting healthy and has been much more productive. He's the tailback at the start of the game. Muema gets the call on first down and has about 3 yards on the first carry of the ball game. Our impact players for this one, when the Aztecs have the ball, Muema with that first down carry. We got lots of stars in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at Quinn Kaler again, a quarterback. Talked about how important he is to keeping this offense going. And then Ederine again at linebacker making plays.
This Fresno State defense will pressure. They use a lot of different blitz packages. Muema, sort of a delayed handoff there, and you can see the power out of Muema when he's healthy, a very strong runner. It looked like he was going to get a yard or two. Instead, he got six.
And then right here, you're going to see Adam Muema again, physical style of running, moving the pile forward, and that's what they need. Now they're in a manageable third down and distance.
Well, Muema, those numbers are very modest coming off a huge year last year as a sophomore, but the health was a problem. He's healthy now. It's third and a short two, first drive of the game. Kaler with a hard count, and Fresno State almost jumped. They'll give it to Muema, cuts up the middle, and he's close, but I don't know. It's going to depend on the spot. Very close to a first down, but he did not get it. Deron Smith, the senior safety, came up in run support. And let's see, the Aztecs are a gambling kind of team. They go for it on fourth down about as much as anybody, and they're not going to go for it here in their own territory. It's not unheard of for the Aztecs to go for it on fourth and one well inside their own territory. Not this time, though. They'll send the punter out, Joel Alisi.
Well, you got to credit Deron Smith for coming and making that tackle short of the first down.
So that's a big stop. The Aztecs, their whole game plan is control the ball. They go three and out. After the punt, Isaiah Burst, the returner, lets it bounce. It'll kick out of bounds. And Fresno State will have the ball. Derek Carr, the fifth-year senior, one of the best quarterbacks in the country, brings his offense on the field.
One of the best quarterbacks, running extremely fast pace, almost 90 plays a game. But where he knows how to, he knows where to go with the football. He understands the structure of the defense. Very difficult to disguise and fool him from your secondary pressure, your blitz packages. Although Rocky Long and this defense have done a great job of that. 3-3-5, they attack you from all sorts of angles.
The wide receivers, great compliments for Carr, and they've got four of them on this first down play, starting at their own 32-yard line. Carr, a little pump fake and going deep down the left sideline. He's got his man, but it's knocked down incomplete. Intended for Greg Watson, the converted quarterback. Second down.
And you'll see right away, Rocky Long again. No hands down on that defense. Everyone standing up, mixing up, kind of confuse the offensive line.
And that is what the Aztecs do. You can see it right here. They try to make it as tough as possible on the quarterback. Carr on second and 10. Pressured a bit. Throws middle. Incomplete. Intended for Isaiah Burst. It's third down. Isaiah Burst, the senior from Modesto, one of those big play guys. The guy who has put up the huge numbers, number 15, Devontae Adams. Third down at Josh Quezada, the junior running back. In the backfield with Carr, who's making his call.
Look at all this activity by that defensive line. You don't know which four or five guys are coming.
Third and 10. A hit on Carr, the pass incomplete. And here comes a late penalty flag. Now the penalty against the Aztecs is going to give Fresno State a first down. The head referee, part of this Mountain West crew, Kevin Marr. We'll wait for the official call from Kevin.
Pass interference. Defense number 34. Ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
J.J. Whitaker called for the pass interference.
And you'll see him outside pressed up on Josh Harper. Yep, and there's contact after he was falling down and grabbed Josh Harper. Great call by the officials.
So a first down on the penalty. Of 13 yards. They're going to give it to Quezada, who's hit in the backfield and dropped. Nice play defensively by Jordan Thomas, who plays end, although he's just 255 pounds in the backfield for the loss.
Well, this defensive line is built on speed, not size. A lot of movement up front.
Fresno State, they like to go quick tempo. They don't always snap the ball quickly, though. They'll get to the line, then let Carr make a call. On second and 12, first possession for the Bulldogs. And Carr pressured again, will throw incomplete, intended for Adams. So early on, that Aztecs pressure, I think, is bothering Derek Carr.
And you'll see right away the different packages that they're throwing at it. They've started to get to Carr already, affecting the throwing motion and the release. That's just as effective as a sack or a hit.
Carr has not completed a pass yet. The guy who completes better than 70% of his passes on the year. It's another third and long, third and 12 this time. Carr in the shotgun. Takes a snap. Just a three-man rush. Carr's pass is incomplete. Hit the hands of the target there. And that's Devontae Adams, who could not come up with it. King Holder with the coverage. Nice defense from San Diego State.
Well, King Holder's one of the guys we were talking about, impact players. They're going to be in a lot of man-to-man situations. They've got to win some of those battles. They've got to tackle, and they can't let those dangerous wide receivers get over the top of them. So far, Rocky Long, this defense, they've got it going.
Garrett Swanson will punt the ball away. Tim Fizzy back to receive. And a high punt, fair catch signal around the 15, just inside the 15. San Diego State, after the defensive stop, will get the ball back when we come back to Qualcomm Stadium. No score very early. Night football this week at NFC West Showdown. Russell Wilson and the Seahawks on the road to take on St. Louis, the Rams. Coverage begins with Monday Night Countdown at 6:30 Eastern, then Seattle and St. Louis Monday at 8:25 on ESPN. Also live on Watch ESPN. Here in San Diego, the Aztecs, after a couple punts, one on each side, the Aztecs will have the ball for the second time in this game. Just 3 minutes in. So Starting for their own 15-yard line and a handoff on first down to Muema. More strong running for 4 yards on first down. Derek Carr and the Bulldogs, David, for the first time all year on their opening drive, did not come away with points.
Absolutely, and that's something strange for this offense. The thing they've done so well this season is attacking people with that first possession and get it up on top of them. A huge little small victory for San Diego State to get them to punt early on, get this offense out of rhythm.
For the Aztecs, part two of the plan is get some stops on defense, but also move the ball, grind off some clock on offense. Kaler back to pass for the first time, and he's going deep over the middle. Incomplete, knocked away. Ezell Ruffin, the intended target.
And those are the shots they've got to take. You've got to threaten that Fresno State secondary along with your run game, the play action game off of it. And that's something they've done very well these last three games, and they've gone 3-0.
Ruffin's the big play guy for the Aztecs through the air, and L.J. Jones, who knocked that ball away, he's their best cover corner. So that was a good matchup there. Third down and 6 for San Diego State. It's still Muema, the tailback, with Kaler under center. Kaler looking. Now scrambling. Kaler's going to throw on the move and throw it away. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down. Good coverage from the Bulldogs.
Great coverage in the secondary by the Bulldogs. Kaler had nowhere to go with that football.
Fresno State's defensive coordinator, his second year, Nick Toth, pleased, I think, with the way his defense has started playing. Alisi again back to punt for the second time in this one. And not really what we expected, three and outs to start this game. Now flags fly as the ball was snapped.
False start. Offense number 9, 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
So the field position gets a little worse for the Aztecs. And a little more pressure on the punter with Isaiah Burrs, who's very dangerous back to receive. He's already returned 2 punts for touchdowns, and they got some pressure, but a beautiful punt. Burrs calls for a fair catch and makes it inside the 40. That was nicely done by the Aztec special teams. Well, Dave Fleming, David Diaz Infante here in San Diego with you here tonight at Qualcomm Stadium. And David, I think this matchup in the Mountain West Conference, Fresno State, they're the headliner, the team that has a chance with those BCS rules because of where they stand undefeated. If they run the table, they got a great shot to make it to the an automatic berth in a BCS bowl game. Their offense really the reason why.
Yeah, the up-tempo offense, Derek Carr, his ability to guide this offense, scoring a lot of points, they're doing a lot of things well. But San Diego State, remember, they're co-conference champions from last year, and they're undefeated in conference as well, so they've got something to say about it. And it starts with them defensively creating some more stops and pressuring Derek Carr. Can they get to him? He's only been sacked 3 times so far this year. Offensive line doing an outstanding job, and Derek Carr's ability to know where to go with the football and get rid of it quickly has been the other element of that.
Yeah, it was Fresno State's first year in the Mountain West last season, and they shared the conference championship with Boise State and San Diego State. This year, for the first time, the Mountain West will have a conference championship game. So that really changes things. But Fresno State already with a win against the Broncos of Boise State as Carr completes a pass to Burch. Right side, he squirts through and nearly broke free. But a nice gain of maybe 7 yards on that first down pass play.
And those bubble screens are just an extension of their run game. When they see the numbers are favorable outside, 3-on-3 with the defensive back off the ball in space, they think it's a plus run for them.
In the shotgun, Carr on 2nd and 3. Looking left, waiting, pressured. He'll step up and throws behind Burse, incomplete. And Carr's upset at himself.
Well, they've gotten the pressure. They're forcing Carr to move his feet, to reset in the pocket. That was a challenge that Rocky Long gave his defense. You've got to defeat the one-on-one blocks, and when there's a free hitter, you've got to affect the throw of Derek Carr. So far, they've been able to do it on these first 2 possessions of the game.
Yeah, Nick Tenoff, the linebacker, put some pressure on there. Carr is 1-for-6 to start this game. Moving again under pressure. Carr trying to get to that edge and reaches the ball forward. We'll see where he's spotted. He may have gotten the first down. I don't think so, though. I think Carr thinks he got it. But that ball spotted shy of midfield. And the 50-yard line, that's where they needed to go. So it's fourth down.
And you'll see, look, no one's standing up. A lot of movement up front, confusing the block at the time of the offensive line. But one thing that Derek Carr does not get enough credit for is his mobility. He's a 4.5 40 type of guy. 4.55. He's got some wheels, some athleticism. He's healthy now this year, and it's really added another dimension to his game.
Well, Fresno State, they like to go for it on fourth down, and they've been very successful. They're going for it here on fourth and one. Carr looks to the sidelines, and Tim DeRuiter asks for a timeout. The play clock was winding down. We'll see if Fresno State thinks about it and sticks with the decision to go for it on fourth down. So the first timeout for Fresno State. We'll take a timeout ourselves. Still scoreless in the first quarter. First quarter, 10:14 to go. Scoreless San Diego State and Fresno State. And the Aztecs defense has been impressive in the early going. Fresno State has a fourth and one from near midfield. Tim DeRuiter indicated he wants to go for it. Called a timeout with the play clock winding down. And he's sending the offense back on the field. So indeed, the Bulldogs are going for it. Third best team in the FBS at converting on fourth down.
Look at the unbalanced look. They got an extra offensive lineman to the right-hand side. And two backs in the backfield. Something they don't do very often.
So a little wrinkle on fourth and one. The big back is Meisenheimer. I think that's Martez Waller, who's on Derek Carr's left. It's Burse in motion. They'll give it to Waller straight ahead, and he powers his way to a first down.
And you see after the timeout, they come in, they go unbalanced, they move the tackle back and forth, trying to affect how San Diego State's going to line up defensively. Some fly motion across, and they put their hammer in Martez Waller, who's a physical downhill runner for him, for the first down.
Well, the Bulldogs into San Diego State territory. Derek Carr, a little pump fake, now running straight ahead with some room, but the hole closes up quickly, gets to the 45. Josh Gavert with the tackle. Gain of four. And one thing about Derek Carr, David, is he's been much more mobile. He's much healthier this year.
Yeah, they talked about it. They don't want him to carry the ball a whole bunch, but they force you to defend it in their zone read game, as well as ability to make plays scrambling if nothing's open downfield.
He played with a sports hernia for a lot of last season, but he's fully healthy here in 2013. Pressured again and scrambling. Carr gets rid of it and throws it away. Good play by Derek Carr to avoid the negative play.
That's what happens when you give a guy like Rocky Long 16 days to prepare for you. Look at the guys coming free, defeating the one-on-ones, get extra blitzers to the quarterback, Derek Carr, forcing them out of the pocket and getting hits on them. That's what Rocky Long's defenses are known for, and that's what they need to do here tonight, and they're doing just that.
Again, it was those linebackers, Tenoff and Gavert, who've been so active in the early going. It's another third down for the Bulldogs. Carr makes the call at the line. Here comes some more pressure, but a pocket for Carr, who throws. He's got Burse, who jumps up, and he made the catch. What a play by Isaiah Burse. 25 yards in the first down.
Well, they fake the pressure and they back out to play coverage, but the perfect throw. Look at the touch on the football. Look at Burse going up and high pointing it and competing for the ball. That's what makes this team special. They have guys that make plays like that all the time and a quarterback that's not afraid to put the ball out there.
So you got the quarterback, plus you have the playmakers on the outside, and Burse, the senior from Modesto, with a big catch there. First down, Carr toward the end zone, jumping up. Burse not this time. Tony Bell with the coverage for the Aztecs.
And again, San Diego State putting pressure on Derek Carr, forcing him not to be able to put that ball in a place where his receiver can make a play on it.
Carr is 2 for 9 to start this game. And yet the Bulldogs are right at the 20-yard line of San Diego State. Adams, his first catch, trying to get to the edge. Powers his way right to the 15 and maybe inside the 15. So Devontae Adams, who has had two huge weeks in a row and is one of the best wide receivers in the country with his first catch of this game.
Yeah, he is big. He's physical. He can run after the catch. And he is a complete guy, and he's tearing it up right now.
Adams has seven touchdown catches in the last two games. He's got 11 on the year. It's third and four inside the 15.
He's isolated right here.
Carr looking that way, instead dumps it off to Waller. Waller, power move, knocked the defender backwards. It got right near the first down mark. I think he got it.
Martez Waller gives a physical presence out of the backfield. Good hands. Watch him lower the shoulder, deliver the blow, and looks like he picked up the first down. Absolutely.
Yeah, King Holder just got knocked backwards. So the Bulldogs with the big play there to get that extra yard. It's first and goal, a place on the field where the San Diego State defense just has not been very good.
Absolutely. They've allowed 18 touchdowns and 19 attempts. But this is where you should have an advantage against spread teams.
It's a wildcat kind of look. Burst takes a direct snap. Isaiah Burst gets to the edge, lunges, and Burst is in. Touchdown. The officials wanted to talk about it and make sure. I think they wanted to make sure he stayed in bounds. He did, 10 yards for the first points of the game.
And that's one of the wrinkles that offensive coordinator Dave Schramm will give you down here tight, is they give it to him in the wildcat burst. And you see the explosion, able to turn the corner and leap into the end zone. Looked like San Diego State strung that play out enough, but his athleticism, we'll see if he steps out of bounds. He is in bounds. What a move. And the score.
So the extra point coming here. Colin McGuire, the freshman, with the kick. It's up and good. 7-0 Fresno State with the lead against San Diego State after an 11-play, 60-yard drive that took just over 3 minutes. So the Bulldogs' offense a little frustrated here in the first quarter. They got some rhythm, and Tim DeRuiter and his team with the first points of the game.
Hey, who can make a play? You know what I'm saying? Nice job. Hey, I have to win the
corner. Now the Bulldogs offense against that Rocky Long defense. It looks like the Aztecs have a good game plan defensively. And yet Fresno State, we saw Burst made two incredible plays there.
Well, you see the diversity within the offense of how they're getting it done.
And we do want to welcome those of you who were watching that thriller, the South Carolina Gamecocks, with an impressive win on the road against top five Missouri. Another team toward the top of the BCS losing. Fresno State, 17th ranked in the BCS, kicks it off after the first points of the game. The short kickoff, and it does not work. The return out to the 40-yard line. The Aztecs of San Diego State will have the possession with good field position here. That's Larry Clark, a wide receiver who came up and caught that short kickoff. So Bob Toledo, offensive coordinator, trying to get the Aztecs offense going. Dave Fleming, David Diaz-Infante, Allison Williams with you here from Qualcomm in San Diego. Fresno State, this could be their toughest test, trying to stay undefeated and have a chance for that automatic berth into a BCS bowl game. They have a very good chance if they can run the table the way things are set up right now. But this one will not be easy tonight. Quinn Kaler and the Aztecs offense. Kaler fumbled the snap, and he'll pounce on it to avoid the turnover.
Those are things they can't afford. Unforced errors. They're not good enough offensively to afford those luxuries. You've got to maintain positive yardage on first down, because they're not a team that plays well from behind the sticks. They're not a big play spread offense type of team. Everything comes off of play action, and they've got to be able to run the football first.
It really is a true contrast in styles with these two offenses tonight. It makes this matchup a lot of fun, I think. The Aztecs started off slowly, but they're undefeated in Mountain West play, so they've played much better coming off a bye week. And the handoff, the true freshman, Donnell Pumphrey, who's got a lot of speed, got to the outside and near midfield. I think he has enough for the first down.
And one of the reasons why their run game has been so effective is number 40, Chad Young. Watch him. He's a fullback in the truest sense, old school throwback. He can seal the edge, get away with a little bit of grab, but you see the speed of Donnell Pumphrey right there.
He has been a changer. There's the fullback, Chad Young, and he's a heck of a player. But Pumphrey, who's much smaller than Chad Young, the true freshman from Las Vegas, 155, maybe 160 pounds. Three straight games, though, with 100 or more yards on the ground. He is a big play weapon.
Yeah, he's shifty. He's really given another dimension offensively.
Saw that average per carry, a pitch play and a trick play. The receiver wants to throw it, and he'll just throw it away. That did not work. Eric Judge flings it out of bounds, second and 10. And yeah, there's some discussion here.
Those things look good on paper sometimes, but boy, you've got to execute them. You got the shot play. That ball just squirts out of his hand. Smart play of throwing it away, though, instead of forcing it.
Well, he's going to get called for a penalty, though. And the officials came together and talked about it. Kevin Maher is going to explain.
Not out of the pocket.
Intentional grounding. Offense number 3. Loss it down. Third down.
Well, it'll be second down, and it wasn't number 3. It was the receiver who got called for the intentional grounding.
Yeah, as you'll see, he's going to be between the tackles in the pocket, and there's no wide receiver over there. He's going to throw it out of bounds.
So you got to throw it towards somebody, or you got to be outside of that tackle area.
Outside the pocket, and also has to cross the line of scrimmage.
Yeah. There's a lot going wrong for the Aztecs on that play. It's second at 17. Taylor in the shotgun brings the receiver in motion. To pass, a pump fake, nowhere to go, finally throws incomplete, throws toward double coverage intended for Izzell Ruffin.
Excellent job of the secondary of Fresno State of sticking to their wide receivers and forcing Kaler to try and beat him from the pocket.
Still has not completed a pass here tonight. And these are the spots. It's not easy for any team in third and long, but the Aztecs offense is not equipped for the third and long situations. We'll see if the Bulldogs bring some pressure. And they do from the outside. The fullback picks up the blitz. Taylor steps up. He's got his man caught. Big gain into Bulldogs territory inside the 30. Eric Judge with the catch and run. 33 yards, first down, Aztecs.
State will bring pressure to the from the field. Again, you'll see it coming here off the edge. Watch the fullback go from the right side of the quarterback to the other side to pick up the blitz and give his quarterback time to throw. Receiver uncovers, Eric Judge, nice throw over the middle. Watch this. That's putting a lick on a blitzer and allowing your quarterback the room to step up.
So a big first down for San Diego State, trailing 7-0, but the Aztecs on the move, and Kaler's going to pass again. He'll throw middle, and it's dropped. Intended for the tight end, Adam Roberts, who had a gain. He might have had a first down, and he dropped it.
When your quarterback gives you the ball over the middle, look, he's got someone in his face. Accurate throw, you're wide open. Those are plays you gotta make.
Particularly a team that's trying to pull off an upset.
And you're playing against a high-powered offense that puts points up on everybody.
So Kaler and company come to the line. It's second and 10 with a tight formation here. Two receivers. And Pumphrey, the true freshman in the backfield. They'll give it to Donnell Pumphrey, looking for a hole. And there wasn't much of one there, although he squirted through. He could be hard to find. He got positive yards on that second down play.
Yeah, he was hiding behind a big Terry Poole at 6'5", over 300 pounds. It's hard to see that little number 19.
So a 4-yard gain sets up third down and 6. The Aztecs, who do not like to kick field goals, and it could well be that this is 4-down territory for San Diego State. They play things on offense in this part of the field a little different than most teams. Taylor, pressure, and his throw is incomplete. He got pushed as he released the ball. Donovan Lewis with just a pure power rush there to force the incompletion.
And Donovan Lewis, that's what he does. You're going to see him get upfield and watch him stiff arm the tackle and lift him up off his feet and get to the throwing arm of Quinn Kaler.
Well, that was a heck of a play, and he is a power rusher, a very physical kid, the junior hometown kid from Fresno. And San Diego State will attempt a field goal here. And for Seamus McMorrow, it's his first ever field goal attempt as a college kicker. He is going to handle the kicking duties. It's a 40-yard attempt from the right hash mark. The first time he's ever tried this in a college game. And he misses wide right, no good. Now, the kicking game has just been a real problem for San Diego State, particularly these last few weeks. And Fresno State dodges the bullet. The Bulldogs offense comes back on the field when we come back to San Diego. Carr and Company leading 7-0.
Cabela's, it's in your nature.
Well, it was a beautiful sunset today in San Diego. We're not far from the beach here inside Qualcomm Stadium. The Bulldogs and the Aztecs. Fresno State undefeated. And the quick hitter, Devonte Adams, on first down. Adams to the sideline. A big hit, but Adams got close to the first down. And some talking and a penalty flag thrown after the play. And I think that one's going against San Diego State. 8 yards, and we'll see how much the penalty adds to that.
Eric Pinkins going to get called.
Well, not a smart play.
You know, these defensive backs talked about that all
week. After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, defense number 27, taunting, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Fresno State, they get enough yards on their own. You don't need to help them out.
Yeah, pre- and post-snap penalties is something they cannot afford, the non-competitive penalties. But you'll see, they talked about being able to take on those wide receivers, how much they got damaged by the bubble screens last year. And so there he is, making a hit, the play. Just walk back to the huddle.
Yeah, it was the talk that did it. That ends up being a 23-yard play with the gain and then the penalty on top of it. Fresno State with the 7-point lead, still the first quarter. Carr steps up against pressure. Scrambling right, still looking downfield. Carr gets tripped up. He falls forward and gains maybe a yard. He has been under some severe heat in this first quarter.
But watch Derek Carr here. He's going to check the protection and bring his back across the formation, pick up the blitz. But he gets upfield pressure again from Sam Meredith that forced him to leave the pocket. Again, great effort picking up positive yardage.
And a pretty good effort there at the end by John Sanchez, the defensive lineman, to trip him up. Make sure it was a real short game. The second down at about 9, nearing midfield.
This is a cat and mouse game going on between Derek Carr and this defense. Where are the blitzers coming from? How does he adjust the protection?
Blitzers come again. Carr switches to the left hand. Now back to the right. He gets a block. He's going to throw across the field, incomplete. Well, a play where the quarterback has to switch hands midway through, usually it's not going well.
That's right. That's tough to do, but I tell you what, consistent pressure by the Aztecs, it's affecting Derek Carr. Look, he's as tough as anybody, as competitive as anybody, but that affects your completions and the rhythm of your offense.
Oh, man, those numbers are really impressive. 14 times he's dropped back to pass, 5 hits, 6 hurries, knocked down a couple times, no official sacks yet. But the pass rush has been a big factor.
Sacks are just icing on the cake. Those pressures and hurries and hits.
3rd and 9, and whistles blow before the ball is snapped.
Delay of game. Offense, 5-yard penalty, 3rd down.
So Tim DeRuiter can't be real thrilled with the way things are going on the offensive side.
That penalty is a direct effect of the pressure and the different looks that San Diego State is giving Derek Carr right now. They're showing all sorts of guys up in the line of scrimmage. You don't know who the down lineman is, who the linebacker is, who the safeties are. They're lining up all over the place and moving.
That was an angry face from Dave Schramm.
Yes, it was. But look at the movement up front by this defense. You don't know who's who and where they're coming from.
Carr back to pass. This time the pressure picked up. He's going deep for Adams. And penalty flag is thrown. There was contact as the ball was on the way. King Holder there, and Adams and Holder now talking. I think that one's going against the Aztecs.
These guys, you don't think there's a little blood between these two teams, you know, and now you got to watch, you know, Pinkins got to watch himself again. You have to have control. This game is emotional. It's for fired up guys, but without the control, you have no game.
Well, I think
there's coach giving him a licking right there, going to get his attention.
Hey, you cannot get a second one of those.
Pass interference. Defense number 35. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
That's a tough call because they're going to be in one-on-one matchups all night. And you'll see him right there. Holder's in great position, but he just bumps him before the ball gets there. That's a little jostling. That's tough. I don't know. That one's close, but you see it. I think maybe Adams initiated part of that contact.
Well, the penalties have been a huge part of the story. Here's Adams with the catch, left side, cuts it upfield. Adams fighting for the first down, stops short of that. But Derek Carr starting to get Devontae Adams, his top receiver, involved. Nat Burhey, who's one of the top playmakers in the secondary, made the tackle.
Yeah, it is. These guys, these guys are fired up. These defensive backs were challenged last year and this week. They know what happened. They left Fresno State back in the game, and Derek Carr burned him for 536 yards.
Here's Harper on the right side. Josh Harper, the junior, turned it upfield along the sideline. First down, Bulldogs.
Well, you'll see one thing these Fresno State wide receivers do is they block for each other on the perimeter of those bubble screens. Critical element to their development as a team in offense. We have guys that, one, are big play guys, but then also buy in the blocking part. Very difficult to defend.
First and 10, Bulldogs after the 7-yard gain. Carr takes a snap. Here comes the pressure. Carr scrambling. He's going down. Well, they've had pressure all game. That's the first time they've gotten the sack. Josh Gafford gets credit for the sack for San Diego State.
You'll see the pressure coming. Look, backer here, backer, backer over here. You're going to see which one's coming and where they come from. They're going to get the pressure up. They're going to defeat the one-on-one block. The coverage is there, and that's all it takes for Gabbert to get there and get the sack finally. They hit Pater.
Yeah, the center, Lars Bramer, slowed up that pass rusher, Gabbert, but he got around and got to Carr. A loss of 8. It's second and 18. Not easy for one of the top offenses in college football. Carr throwing left side. Adams again out there. Adams incomplete. It was Perkins with the coverage.
And you'll see right there, the throw was there. Great touch by Derek Carr with someone in his face. That's something he does as well as anybody in the country. But watch the defensive effort. The hands up by Eric Pinkins, who's also 6'3". That's a matchup they like. Size against size. Length against length.
The third and 18 after the defensive play by Eric Pinkins, the senior from Sacramento. Third and 18. Five receivers, empty backfield with Carr. And now more whistles. More flags thrown. It could be that that clock expired.
Prior to the penalty, timeout Fresno State. They're second of the half.
So they got the timeout to avoid the 5-yard penalty. We'll take a timeout of our own. It hasn't been easy for the Fresno State offense. They do lead 7-0.
ESPN College Football Finale. Brought to you by Cabela's. Cabela's. It's in your nature.
From San Diego, the Bulldogs with a 7-0 lead, but Rocky Long and his San Diego State defense have dialed up the pressures. They have made it very tough on Derek Carr so far.
Yeah, they're disguising and showing pressure one way, rotating everybody over and bringing it from the field or boundary. Linebackers and safeties attacking the line of scrimmage.
After a sack, a timeout that avoided the delay game penalty, Derek Carr and the Bulldogs with a third and 18 inside Aztecs territory. Carr with time this time. He's going to throw middle, and the pass is tipped up and incomplete. Burhey, Nat Burhey with a nice break on the ball. It's fourth down and very long.
And that time they corral Derek Carr in the pocket. They bring a four-man rush and they play covers behind it. And that's what Rocky Long was talking about they need to do. is when they just get four there, can they collapse a pocket? And two, can we play coverage underneath it? Look at the matchups right there. Everybody has a man. Nowhere to go with the football. Outstanding job of reading his eyes and making a break on the ball by Burhead.
Part of the field where Fresno State, I'm sure, was thinking field goal, four down territory. But on fourth and 18, they'll punt the ball and try to pin the Aztecs deep. San Diego State doesn't even send back a return man. The bounce, and that one is a touchback. Now the two officials got together to talk about it, and they'll say touchback, which is a big break for San Diego State.
Yeah, absolutely. Correct call there, because the Fresno State player, Peck, he was in the end zone as he downed the ball, I believe. His foot is on the line, and he comes in. I think that's a correct call.
Now, the punter can't believe it. It was a good punt by Garrett Swanson, and there was a real chance to pin the Aztecs inside the two-yard line. Instead, San Diego State takes over at the 20.
Absolutely. Good lesson there. If you have a chance to field the ball in the air, you've got to do it inside the 10.
And the Aztecs offense, first and 10, Quinn Kaler, the quarterback, under center with a play fake. And rolling right, he'll throw on the move. He's got his man caught. And a play turned upfield, breaking tackles across the 40. Nice effort there by Izell Ruffin with the catch and run.
A great way to get your quarterback in rhythm is to move him, to get him on the run outside the pocket. You'll see Ruffin right here run the route, work back to his quarterback, and then break a tackle and pick up extra yards. Hey, Ruffin's a guy, too, that's been hot lately. He's a big play guy for San Diego State. He's a matchup problem as well at 6'1" and thick in the lower body.
Those are the numbers to back that up. He has turned it up. Kaler over the middle, incomplete. Good coverage there. So on first down, the pass for the Aztec. Kyrie Wilson with the coverage, and it was good coverage. A guy's been around college football a long time, wearing the white hat there, Bob Toledo. He's been a head coach at several different stops, most prominently at UCLA. He's found his way to San Diego. He's the offensive coordinator for the Aztecs. Kaler almost a pistol formation. Pumphrey, and I think that was a broken play. Kaler running with the ball, and he doesn't do that very often. Did get positive yards, though, so he made something out of nothing. I don't think that was the way they wanted it to work.
Hey, quick thinking on his feet, right? Broken play, follow the running back where he's going, turns into an extra blocker. He's got to get down, pick up the yardage. Now they're find themselves a manageable third down distance.
So the play gains 6 yards. It's third and 4. Fresno State, though, has a player down on the field.
You know, and Bob Toledo's been very pleased with Quinn Kaler's development. You know, not a great arm talent, but boy, knows where to go with the football, knows what they're trying to do offensively. Let's see.
That looks like L.J. Jones, the fifth-year senior from Los Angeles, who's the cover corner. It was Jones who came in to make that tackle.
Hard to see what happened. You see him grabbing his left knee there.
Yeah, so he's in some pain, and he is the best cover corner that Fresno State has. They've had some problems in that area. Fresno State's defense has given up a lot of big plays this season.
Yeah, they certainly have 35 explosive plays. That's plays of 20-plus yards. It's been an issue. It's been better the last 2 weeks, but, boy, early in the season, been a big issue for them.
So they are hoping that Jones is okay. Timeout here on the field. Back here in San Diego, and that could be very bad news for Fresno State. L.J. Jones, their best cover cornerback, the senior, looks like he's in a lot of pain. It was a left knee problem. He's being helped off the field. So that sent us to the timeout. Aztecs have the ball, third down coming up. We get a moment to remind you there are only 4 races left. The chase for the Sprint Cup in the home stretch. Jimmy Johnson, Matt Kenseth lead the chase field into historic Martinsville Speedway. NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Martinsville, Sunday at 1 Eastern. On ESPN. Dave Fleming, David Diaz Infante here from Qualcomm Stadium in San Diego. The Aztecs right near midfield, a 3rd and 4 for San Diego State's offense, trailing 7-0, still in the first quarter. Taylor will hand the ball off to true freshman Pumphrey, trying to get to the corner. He does, and he gets the first down. There's some of that burst for a kid who's been a real difference maker the last few weeks for San Diego State.
And you'll see Pumphrey gives them some explosiveness at the running back position. Look, speed sweep. Watch number 40, the fullback. Boom, lower the shoulder, deliver the blow, and Pumphrey knows what to do after that. Huge third down conversion for San Diego State there to keep the ball away from Derek Carr and that Fresno State offense before the end of the first quarter.
So the combo, the power of the fullback Young, the speed of Pumphrey, the freshman. First and 10 into Bulldogs territory. Kaler, the short drop, pressured. And Kaler somehow manages to wiggle free, throws, and the pass is caught. Not a big gain, but they avoid the negative play. Adam Roberts, the tight end, held on for a gain of 4.
Quinn Kaler, better athlete. People think he showed some real toughness through his last 3 games. He's 3-1 as a starter, and that's why. Good decision with the football. Finds a way to make a play for his team. And there's Adam Roberts making a tough catch when his team needed it. Positive yards on first down.
Now, they don't use the tight end a lot, but they think Roberts is a talented playmaker at that spot. Second and 6. Kaler under center. It's Pumphrey in the backfield. They'll give it to Donnell Pumphrey. He got hit hard, got a yard, maybe 2, to set up third down. Charles Washington, who's playing a lot better, Young safety with the tackle. And that is the end of quarter number 1 from San Diego, 17th ranked Fresno State with the 7-0 lead. Second quarter, 7-0 Fresno State with the lead. Dave Fleming, David Diaz Infante. Let's welcome in the third member of our broadcast team, Allison Williams. Allison?
Well, Dave, in that first quarter, we saw this Fresno State offense struggle to find its groove. It's just the second time all year that they've scored 7 points or less in the first quarter. So during this San Diego State drive, Derek Carr spent a lot of time on the bench chatting with offensive coordinator Dave Schramm, going over coverages, what's open, what's not, and just making sure they're both seeing the same thing. Right now, it doesn't sound like they're on the same page. We know how much trust the staff has in Carr and his ability, but they're trying to get synced up right now.
All right, Allison, thanks. On that third down play, Donnell Pumphrey got enough for the first down, so the Aztecs still on the move. A little more time for Derek Carr and company to think about things.
Well, they're trying to crack the code right now. You know, when Rocky Long has 16 days to prepare for you, you know there's going to be some twists and some exotic blitzes. They've been doing that so far in the first part of this game.
San Diego State has moved the ball pretty effectively after their first drive, which was a 3-and-out. Kaler throws short, and the pass is caught by the fullback Young for a very short gain. The ball came out, but he was down. Carl Mickelson, the linebacker, in on the hit. It's easy to spot Carl Mickelson, who's from San Diego.
Got the hair flowing. I like it.
And junior, they've got lots of San Diego presence on this roster. They have a presence on the Chargers NFL roster from Fresno State. So there are some connections from the Bulldogs program to this town. 9th play of the drive for the Aztecs. Taylor, the short drop, again the short pass, and again it's the fullback Young with the completion. And a gain of 5 to bring up third down.
I really like what Bob Toledo's doing right now within the passing game. One, moving the pocket, some quick throws out to the flats, a quick hookup. Some spacing concepts, you know, where he could drop the 5, get rid of the ball quickly, and build the confidence of your quarterback. And so I like what they're doing right now, mixing in the run game, getting the ball to Pumphreys. I like it.
The fullback leaves the backfield, so it's Pumphrey who's back there alone. Kaler on third down got hit as he throws, and the pass is incomplete. That was Mickelson, who got in very quickly with the pressure.
And you see number 43, Mickelson again. It's a cross dog up in the middle. Offensive linemen get confused, and there he comes clean for the hit.
So a missed assignment, perhaps up front. Fourth down, 44-yard field goal if they attempt it. And we've already seen the kicking game for the Aztecs, so they're not going to do that, and they'll go for it on fourth down.
Yeah, and Rocky Long doesn't mind going for anything. There's a question with your kicking game. Hey, let's go for it. You know, Bob Toledo gives him a chance to be more creative in his play calling.
So big play here. Pressure comes for the Bulldogs. Picked up initially, but the pass is incomplete. Colin Lockett was there, and I think he had a chance to haul that one in, but incomplete, and the Bulldogs will take over.
And Colin Lockett, the senior, out of Diamond Bar again. He's open. The shallow crossing route right there. He is open for the first down. The ball is there. Those are plays you got to make when you're trying to beat the number 17 team in the BCS rankings, team that's 6-0. Those opportunities within the red zone or around the red zone, boy, you got to take advantage of them.
Hey, he's a good player. He's been playing well.
Big play guy for them. Those are plays he normally makes.
Well, that's a real mistake because the drive would have continued. Instead, Fresno State will have the ball when we come back. Fresno State leads 7-0. It is homecoming for the Aztecs tonight here in San Diego. The Aztecs move the ball, but their drive ends. They could not convert on fourth down. So Derek Carr and company with the first down play. The quick catch, short gain for Isaiah Burse. Let's check in the studio with Wendy Nix. Wendy.
Thank you. It's a Taco Bell Live Moss moment, courtesy of South Carolina quarterback Connor Shaw. This play on fourth down in overtime. The 15-yard connection to Bruce Ellington, the Gamecocks, go on to pull off the upset in double OT, knocking off undefeated Mizzou.
All right, Wendy, thanks. So that's a very big, big moment in this college football season. Missouri going down at home. They led 17-0. That's hard to believe.
Well, I tell you, the old ball coach got it done. But again, another SEC team drops out of top 25 or loses over the course of the weekend. Last week, teams went down, and now Mizzou.
Third and 10 for the Bulldogs. And Carr got into position quickly. Still has time on that play clock to make an adjustment. Aztecs showing some pressure. They rush just four. Carr steps up. Looking downfield. He's going to run. He has nowhere to go. Forced out of bounds. So it's fourth down for the Bulldogs. And presumably Fresno State's going to punt the ball away.
San Diego State's been doing a great job of mixing up pressure and playing coverage. That time they only rushed four. Great job in the back half of covering up the wide receivers. Derek Carr, even when buying time, had nowhere to go with the football.
So Garrett Swanson comes on to punt once again. The Bulldogs have had the ball four times and they've punted three times. That is just about unheard of the way their offense has played so far this season. Swanson gets off another good punt. Fair catch by Vizzy, and he makes it outside the 20, around the 22-yard line. Let's check in once again on the sideline with Allison Williams.
Well, a significant loss for this Fresno State defense. They will be without their senior corner, L.J. Jones. They're calling it a left leg injury. You can see his knee is ice, and he is on crutches here on the sideline. So they will be without one of their leaders on this defense.
Now, there's the play where it happened. You see his knee just got bent awkwardly there as he went in to make the tackle. And he was in a lot of pain when they helped him off the field. So that's tough for L.J. Jones, who's played really well this season. And the defense back on the field for Fresno State and without their best coverage corner. Green Taylor, the quarterback, under center. Moema back in the backfield. The play fake to Moema, and then Taylor is sacked back at the 10. And there's Adro Edirine, who's been a big pass rusher for Fresno State.
Edirine coming off the edge right here. You're going to see him get the pressure on the play action, come inside the tight end, defeat the block, and right up the middle. Quinn Kaler, nowhere to go with the football. Huge sack for Fresno State.
So the loss of nine. The Bulldogs third in college football in tackles for loss, negative plays on defense. And there's another one there. Almost four sacks a game for the Bulldogs.
San Diego State.
Now San Diego State will use their first timeout of this first half. So we'll take a timeout ourselves. 7-0. The Bulldogs have the lead.
ESPN College Football Finale. Brought to you by Dr. Pepper. Always one of a kind.
Gas Lamp District in downtown San Diego. It's always hopping downtown. We're just a few miles away from there. 7-0 Fresno State, 17th ranked team in the initial BCS standings. 6-0 but up against an undefeated conference opponent, San Diego State, 3-3 overall. The Aztecs defense has played very well considering their offense, though, trying to get it going after a sack. It's 2nd-and-19 for San Diego State, just under 11 minutes to go in the first half. Taylor, the play fake and rolling right. He's going to throw back left. Muemba, the running back, with the catch, but the defense swarms to the ball. And so Muemba got back to the line of scrimmage and not much more.
Again, Donovan Lewis, you'll see him from his linebacker position. Great job of diagnosing the screen. Watch him come up and attack the line of scrimmage, go between the two offensive linemen and make the play. Outstanding job. Correct vision, instincts. I love it.
Donovan Lewis, big playmaker at that linebacker spot, getting better and better. The Fresno State coaches are seeing a lot more big plays from him. Reine on the other side of things, creating pressure. Carl Mickelson has played well for the Bulldogs from the linebacker spot. 3rd-and-very-long. Kaler has his man, and it's caught, complete for a first down along the left sideline to the 35-yard line. Eric Judge with the big play through the air, 21 yards.
Watch again. You're going to see him run the comeback. He's going to break inside and then break back outside. Accurate throw by Quinn Kaler. The protection was there. The throw was there. The catch was there.
So that's a big time play on 3rd-and-very-long, deep in their own territory. 1st-and-10, San Diego State. The junior running back Adam Muemba still in the game. They'll fake the ball to Muemba. Aztecs are throwing the ball a lot. This pass is intercepted. What an interception there. Great play, and it's Donovan Lewis again. The linebacker looking like a cornerback going up and snatching the ball from Kaler.
And you'll see Donovan Lewis again making plays just like we talked about. See, the protection is there. The blitz is there. They're going to pick it up here. Give Kaler time to throw the football. But then you'll watch the depth in the drop and reading of the eyes by Donovan Lewis. Nice job of making the play.
I doubt Kaler thought that Lewis would be anywhere close to the ball there. That was a heck of an effort from a very good athlete who's making a lot of plays in this first half. Derek Carr gets the ball back. 7-0 Fresno State. First turnover of the game. Carr, a little pump fake. Still trying to find somewhere to go with the ball, and he throws it low, incomplete. This Bulldogs offense just has not gotten it going.
Well, you have to credit what San Diego State's doing on defense. They're giving a lot of different looks, varying their pressures, 4-, 5-, and 6-man pressures, playing zone and man behind it, too. But one thing that Fresno State's been done outstanding job of so far this season is they've scored 62 points off of the turnovers their defense has created.
2nd-and-10. Carr. Giving some signals out to the right side. Those wide receivers stacked up one on top of the other. Carr looking left, though. Throws left, and it's knocked down incomplete. Intended for Adams. More good Aztecs defense. David Lamar with the pass defense.
They stacked the receivers to try and defeat man coverage. Look at the job by David Lamar of staying with his receiver, getting the hand out in front, and breaking up that pass.
Donovan Lewis, who made that great interception, they are working on him on the sidelines, and looks like getting an ankle brace fitted, the shoe back on. He gave the Bulldogs offense the ball back, but now it's 3rd-and-10 for Derek Carr and company. Carr with time, middle, caught, and a broken tackle. Close to the first down. Josh Cazada, the running back, made the first man miss, and he got close, but he did not get there. He's a yard and a half or two short of the first down, a gain of 8.
And look, Fresno State's going to go for it again on 4th down. Again, missed tackles almost allowed Fresno State to convert that 3rd down.
So 4th down, they've gone for it once, and they converted near this spot of the field earlier in this first half. Carr gets the snap, will hand it off, and the ball carrier's tackled short. Quezada does not get it. The Aztecs defense holds once again. Cody Gallia with a heck of a play from his defensive end spot. San Diego State playing very well on defense here tonight.
And you'll see Cody Gallia coming off the edge, a tackle for a loss, and stops Fresno State on 4th down.
Dave Fleming, David Diaz Infante back here in San Diego. 7-0 Fresno State, but the Aztecs defense with another big stop for the Bulldogs.
And again, it's pressure off the edge. Watch this Fresno State offensive line. They've got five hats to block five. They only blocked four of them. They're going to leave two guys off the edge clean. The inside guy's got the angle to the running back. Makes the tackle for a loss on fourth down. Pressure has been the key to San Diego State's defense so far in this game.
Well, the Aztecs defense statistically has not played very well this year, but they've gotten better lately, and they have used their bye week and are playing a heck of a game here tonight. The quick hitter on the right side and a broken tackle. Into the open, it's Ruffin down the sideline, inside the 10, and finally knocked out of bounds. He was one-on-one. He broke the initial tackle, and he got a big gain for the Aztecs.
Well, Bob Toledo was talking about how physical Ruffin is, and here's a great example. Look at the soft coverage. Great decision by the quarterback. Look at the stiff arm and the power, and now he's up the sideline. That's strength and some length in the arms.
Curtis Riley, the defensive back, he just got knocked to the ground 44 yards. So Ruffin with the big play, and it's first and goal right at the 10-yard line for San Diego State. Quinn Caley, the quarterback under center, will hand the ball off. Buema looking for a hole, and there was nothing there. Stop for no gain.
And that's a situation where Moema's got to plant that left foot and just knock it up in there. Believe a crease will take place. You can't start running sideways. Bend it back, hit it in that A-B gap, and get three nasty yards for your offense.
Aztecs defense hasn't been very good in the red zone. Their offense hasn't been great either. This part of the field just hasn't been great for the Aztecs, but you see the improvement. And that's sort of the theme for this San Diego State team in all phases. Roberts, the tight end in motion. Buema squirts through, and Adam Buena into the end zone. Touchdown. An extra point away from tying this game. 10 yards for Adam Buema. Defense got the stop on fourth down. Three plays later, Aztecs into the end zone.
And most importantly, the defense gets a stop after the interception. Look at the fullback. They get a hat on a hat, black jersey on white jersey, with Chad Young leading the way for the touchdown, San Diego State.
He's been a factor, the fullback Young, in this first half. The Aztecs points on the board for the first time. Buema with the touchdown run. San Diego State, their defense playing well. Now their offense has joined the party, a 7-7 game. San Diego State touchdown has tied this game 7-7, 7:38 to go in the first half. Sunday, 10 a.m. Eastern on ESPN. It's NFL Countdown presented by IBM, getting you ready. All the latest news and updates from around the league. This week, Ray Lewis interviews his old defensive coordinator, Jets head coach Rex Ryan. That ought to be interesting. Then at 11 a.m. on ESPN2, Fantasy Football Now. You can get the latest news, injury reports, and predictions for the top fantasy performers. Kickoff as Fresno State will get the ball back here. Return out across the 15, but the big hit short of the 20. Dave Fleming, David Diaz Infante from San Diego. Todd McShay, our NFL draft insider, back in our studios. Todd, Derek Carr, who's put up huge numbers this year, having a tough time tonight. What's your opinion on Derek Carr and his future at the next level in the NFL?
Well, first of all, he has the size you look for, adequate size. He's adequate mobility within the pocket. He is unbelievably good in tangibles, work ethic, and everything you look for in terms of the mental makeup. Now, physically, I think he's kind of average across the board in terms of arm strength, accuracy. He's much better short to intermediate than he is down the field, but he also plays in an offense where you're not throwing vertically a whole lot, too. So he reminds me a lot of Andy Dalton coming out of TCU. To me, there's some limitations there, but if you're using an offense that focuses a lot on the West Coast, shorter intermediate throws, he can be successful at the next level.
All right, interesting stuff from Todd McShay. Derek Carr and company, their offense having a real tough time here tonight so far.
Absolutely. That's the San Diego State defense finding ways to pressure them. And so far, they've done a great job tackling in space, eliminating the big player over the top.
All right, Todd, thanks for the insight. We'll look forward to hearing from you again at halftime. Well, Todd McShay with some thoughts about Derek Carr, the fifth-year senior. Another third down for the Bulldogs.
Well, one thing Derek Carr has going for him, too, is he's played in a pro-style system under Pat Hill before, now playing in the spread. I really think he throws a great deep ball touch. He doesn't drive the ball like Todd was talking about, but his touch ball, I think he's got great feel for that part of the game.
Third and seven, San Diego State with some pressure coming, and it's a quick hitter over the middle. The pass caught. Harper stayed on his feet, fighting toward the first down. Great effort from Josh Harper, and we'll see. He might have gotten it with the second effort. There was no way he was going to get that first down and somehow kept his balance.
Well, it's great job by everyone involved. Look, they beat man coverage. They bring him underneath. Look at the effort by Harper, and look at the black jerseys flying at him. It's going rat, tat, tat. Look at the balance. Look, there's guys coming from all angles at him.
Now that was just a tremendous play from the junior Josh Harper. 7 yards, and they needed every inch of those 7 yards. That's a first down for the Bulldogs. Carr hits Harper again. Very similar pass play, this time the tackle after a gain of 4.
And now they're starting to get to the part of their offense going, okay, you're going to play man coverage against us. We're going to give you our man beaters. We're going to stack our wide receivers, run some natural picks and rub routes to free these guys up.
Carr, it's Adams, left side, gets a block, but gets shoved out of bounds just short of the first down mark. So another short gain through the air. Third down for the Bulldogs. Gain of 4. Forget the game average. Fresno State has averaged just under 30 points a game in the first half. They have 7 here tonight against San Diego State. Just a much different story for the Bulldogs. Carr, pump fake, hit, and the ball's on the ground. Scooped up, headed toward the end zone. The tackle at the 15. John Sanchez came up with it. They did not rule it a pass. They ruled it a fumble. So more pressure. DeRuiter thinks it was an incomplete pass. But for now, it's a turnover.
You're going to see the pressure right up the gut, and they're going to try and run a bubble and go. It takes more time, and they're going to pay the price. You're going to see linebackers coming right up the middle. They're going to in the cross dog. There he is. Boom. Makes a hit when Carr tries to pump. The fumble and the recovery. San Diego State.
What a first half for Josh Gavert, the junior linebacker from Lakewood, California. He put the hit on.
Ruling on the field was a fumble.
Now they are going to review this one. Tim DeRuiter is convinced that the arm was coming forward, and that's an incomplete pass. And I don't know.
He's doing his best to give a calm demeanor, at least. And we'll see if the arm's going forward. Looks like he's beginning it. Boy, I think the
it's
arm
a tuck
is
rule play. Tuck.
Yeah, I know. Boy, just what the Raider fans want to hear, huh?
Yeah, we got some Raider fans, I'm
yeah,
sure,
absolutely.
Watching this game.
Especially up in the valley there, huh?
Well, the arm was definitely coming forward. The question is, he was starting to pull the ball back to the body. And you know why the coach, Tim DeRuiter, is thinking that should be an incompletion. He saw that arm come forward, but you can also see what Derek Carr was trying to do, pull the ball back.
There's the first pump, and now there's the other one. Boy, he brings the ball back into his body. Otherwise, that ball would have been gone.
So the officials are taking a look at this one. Bob Bain is the replay official, and of course, in college football, the head referee just waits for the replay official to make the call here upstairs. The replay official will take as many looks as possible. Ruling on the field is fumble. The evidence has to be indisputable to overturn that ruling on the field.
And again, Josh Gavert making some big plays. And this one, boy, momentum has swung in San Diego State's way. If this call goes their way, and I think, you know, it'll be interesting to see the arms going forward.
And it could be that the ball was coming out there. He could sort of see the ball moving as he's trying to bring the ball back and pump fake. The ball was moving. So it's obviously a big call here. The ruling on the field of a fumble if the turnover stands. Aztecs have it at the Fresno State 15.
And again, that was on third down too, so it'll force Fresno State to punt either way. But boy, a difference in field position. But either way, the hits and the pressures, I don't care who you are, it takes its toll on a quarterback over the course of four quarters.
Derek Carr just waiting. We thought we were going to get a ruling from the head referee, and then there was a hesitation. So
he does not look rattled there. He does not look rattled.
He is a cool customer. You can see the ball moving there. Yeah. And I think if they rule this an incompletion, there's some justification for that.
And the arm was clearly going forward.
Even if the intention was to tuck the ball back away and pump fake, I think the ball started to come out of his hands as his arm was coming forward. So they're chatting about it. The offense just has not been what we expect from Fresno State. And now those numbers averaging better than 555 yards a game tonight, 102 yards of total offense. So not just the lack of points, they have not moved the ball.
Yeah, well, and you know, it's because what San Diego State and Rocky Long is doing. Look, you got 16 days to prepare for an opponent. Look, these guys have been around a long time. Rocky Long has seen this offensive evolution take place over a period of years now. He's been running this defense for a while. It's built on confusion, speed, and attacking the quarterback. They've done exactly that so far through the first quarter and a half here.
A long review, a lot to sort through, and now we are going to get the official ruling here. Call on the field was a fumble, Aztecs ball. But Kevin Marr will give us the official call here now. Both coaches are anxious to hear what's going on.
After further review, the quarterback's arm was in motion, therefore it's an incomplete pass. It'll be fourth down and two at the 36-yard line. Please reset the game clock to 5:47.
They did have a lot to sort through there, David. Once they decided it was going to be an incompletion, not a fumble, they had to get the clock right. They had to get the down and distance.
Yeah, right.
They had to get the line of scrimmage. So that's part of the reason why a replay like that, a review like that, takes so much time. Rocky Long is unhappy, but it will be a punt from Fresno State. The Aztecs are going to get the ball back. It's just a very different situation. Rene Silvano, who does not return a lot of punts, he's back for the Aztecs this time. Swanson has been a lot more active than usual. He booms one here. Silvano just gets out of the way. It's going to take a Fresno State bounce. Great punt inside the 10, all the way down toward the 5-yard line. What a difference. The call overturned instead of the 15 of the Bulldogs. The Aztecs will have it at their own 5-yard line. That was a 59-yard punt with no return.
Well, these are those situations you practice, too, coming out of your own end zone in tight spaces. But this fits their offense. I mean, they're going to line up. They're going to pound the ball. They're going to play action you a little bit. And so far, they've dominated time of possession. It's a tie ball game with the 17th ranked team in the BCS. They came to this place 6-0, undefeated, one of the high powered, high scoring offenses, coming averaging over 45 points a game.
The first and 10 Aztecs. Quinn Kaler under center. Completes a pass right side. Ruffin uses that stiff arm again. That's been a weapon for him across the 20. Right to the 20. A first down and a gain of about 14 yards for San Diego State.
And a lot of times these plays would just be tagged on the end of this run. Look, if you see one-on-one out there, soft coverage, give it to our playmaker Ruffin. You see the strength, you see the power, and yards after the catch.
Ruffin, three catches, 81 yards, and a lot of yards after the catch for Ruffin. First and 10 Aztecs. Clock moving. Now 5 minutes to go first half. Not a lot of room there for Mueba. He fights forward and gets a yard. Let's send it back to the studios for another update.
Thank you very much. It's a Land Rover above and beyond moment, and it belongs to Jordan Lynch. How about this? 4 touchdowns.
here, another team trying to grab one of those automatic berths from a non-automatic qualifying conference. Fresno State and Northern Illinois, very similar in terms of their spot in the college football landscape this year. A lot tougher times here tonight for Fresno State, and now a timeout. San Diego State did not like the way that offensive play was lining up. The Aztecs used their second timeout of this first
timeout,
half.
San Diego State, their second of the half.
So we'll take a break once again from Qualcomm. We've got a 7-7 ball game. Monday Night Football, an NFC West showdown. Russell Wilson and the powerful Seahawks on the road to take on the St. Louis Rams. Coverage begins with Monday Night Countdown at 6:30 Eastern, then Seattle-St. Louis Monday 8:25 on ESPN. Also live on Watch ESPN. Second and 8, San Diego State, the swing pass. Pumphrey, the true freshman, dives forward and gets the first down. They needed 8. He got 8.5.
And that's Bob Toledo using that timeout well to scheme up a play to their playmaker, Donald Pumphrey. Again, you're going to see it's going to look like bubble, but he's going to turn it up inside. The defense overruns them, and he gets it right up the seam.
So Donnell Pumphrey has been an impact player again for the Aztecs this week. He's their new weapon on offense. True freshman, they were not expecting him to play much this year, if at all, and he just forced his way in there. Play fake to Muema. Baylor going deep right sideline, and the pass is incomplete. There was a little contact intended for the speedster, Colin Lockett. Kaler came close, but didn't get one there.
Lockett had a step, but the ball just overthrown slightly. But I like the aggressive mentality. You got to take your shot plays. You got to tell them that we will threaten the back end of your defense as well as throw our short passing game and then run the football as well.
Now that has been a part of San Diego State's offense, taking some shots deep. Now the Fresno State defense has played well in this game. Just a much different score than we're used to seeing with the Bulldogs involved. 7-7, under 4 minutes to go, first half. Kaler under huge pressure, and he threw it right toward the defense, got hit as he threw the ball. It's 3rd and 10.
Again, looked like they're trying to set up a screen. Again, watch the pressure. There's always a delicate balance as an offensive line when you're setting up a screen of how long do you block the defensive lineman, what's too soon to let him go. And it all affects your quarterback and his ability to get the ball to his running back or his tight end, whatever your screen game is.
Now Curtis Riley, the defensive back who came in as part of that pressure, a little bit of late contact there. You saw that there, and he tried to sell it to the official that there was no penalty, and no penalty was called. I think a very good no call. So 3rd and 10. Vizzy, the receiver who came in motion. Kaler in the shotgun. He's got time. He'll throw, and the pass is caught for a first down. It's Ruffin again, having a huge first half. Across the 45, brought down around the 46. It's a 17-yard gain.
And you'll see Ruffin again, soft coverage. He's going to drive off the ball, a deep in-breaking route. The ball is there. The protection was there. Excellent job by San Diego State on 3rd and long to convert and retain possession of the football.
And the coverage here was Jamal Ellis, David, and that's he's taken the spot of L.J. Jones, the top cover cornerback who's out with a leg injury, we think a knee injury. Kaler on first down, throws, and it's another completion. Again, Ruffin. Another big game for the big play man, Ezell Ruffin.
This is where your offense is really working together. You're going to see the pressure come off the edge. The back's going to pick up the blitzer. The quarterback, Kaler, is going to step up into the protection. Look at that. Both backs pick up edge pressure. He steps up, takes a hit, and the wide receiver, Ruffin, makes a difficult catch in tight coverage.
Now that one for 16 yards. Ruffin has 5 catches, 114 yards in the first half for the Aztecs. Pressure up the middle and an incompletion. Kaler did well to get that ball off intended for the tight end. Man, Carl Mickelson once again just timed it perfectly.
Well-timed pressure right up the middle. You're going to see him right in the A-gap. The offensive guard, one rule is that you don't block a blitzer in a screen game, but when he's that close and your quarterback's under center, I believe you have to bump him to slow him down.
So Mickelson coming back to his hometown playing for the Bulldogs against San Diego State, and he's played well. 2nd and 10, Aztecs into Fresno State territory at the 38-yard line. Nicholson again showed pressure. The handoff, Pumphrey, and Pumphrey just could not quite squirt through. There might have been a big gain there. Pumphrey gets 3 yards to bring up third down.
We'll have the right call in into the pressure from Fresno State. They're bringing it up inside, and they're going to get to the perimeter. But a nice job by the safeties of Fresno State of coming up, especially Donovan Lewis again coming over the top to make that play.
And you saw that smile on Pumphrey's face. I think he knew he almost had one there. He could see that daylight up ahead. Taylor under center. It's third and 8 for the Aztecs. And again, it could be 4 down territory. We'll see. Back to pass. Taylor pressured and brought down. Behind the line of scrimmage, it's a Bulldog sack. And there he is. Zetterine gets more pressure and another sack on the quarterback.
And you're going to see they're going to bring double-edged pressure off the edges. Again, the back has one, and the other outside backer beats the left tackle. You'll see it right there. It's Zetterine again coming off the edge. Pressure gets to the quarterback. Man coverage. No one uncovered down the field.
Now, the Fresno State coaches who were at Texas A&M with Von Miller, all-pro pass rusher extraordinaire in the NFL, and they're not trying to compare the two, but they do believe Zetterine's got some of those same pass rush instincts, just the natural talent for rushing the quarterback as the guy they had
offense
at College Station.
Penalty. Still fourth down.
Delay a game there.
And you're right, and just a sophomore too. And they think when he starts to develop more in the weight room, boy, he's going to be really something special. He's a guy they can bring off the edge, blitz from different areas, and can beat offensive linemen one-on-one with his ability to bend and dip. It's very similar to the way Von Miller does.
The punt as try to pin Fresno State deep. Burst, fair catch, makes it around the 11-yard line. Bulldogs get the ball back. Let's check in once again with the studio.
Thank you very much. I'm Wendy Nix, getting set for our BMW halftime report. South Carolina completes the comeback and knocks off Missouri. The top four teams in the country played like the top four teams in the country. And Johnny Manziel looked every bit the Heisman Trophy winner and perhaps candidate. We'll talk about that with Todd McShay and Robert Smith coming up at the half.
All right, Wendy, thanks. The Bulldogs of Fresno State, they think their quarterback is a Heisman candidate, Derek Carr, but he's not playing like one. It's not all on Carr. The Aztecs defense has been very impressive. Bulldogs certainly equipped with their style for the two-minute style offense. First down, burst with the catch, and he just had nowhere to go. Maybe got 4 or 5 yards. Clock continues to run. So second down for the Bulldogs. Carr trying to get organized. Fresno State only has the one timeout. So precious time ticking away in this 7-7 game. A long way to go for the Bulldogs. This pass is incomplete, intended for Harper. That'll stop the clock, but it's third down. Just remarkable, Derek Carr, whose statistics are about as impressive as anybody's in the country. And yet a very modest first half.
Absolutely. And you have to give credit to what San Diego State's done on the defense side of the ball. They combined pressure packages, playing coverage, bouncing back and forth from man to zone, never giving them the same look twice.
And the walk-on Quinn Kaler, the quarterback for the Aztecs, a long way from a Heisman Trophy candidate. He maybe has outplayed Derek Carr. The short pass, Quezada can't get the first down. He gets tackled short of the first down. And that's going to force the Bulldogs, I think, to punt the ball away again, although with the clock winding, they won't have to do it if they don't want to. Aztecs could stop the clock and force them to punt. We'll see what Rocky Long decides.
Well, that's one thing that the San Diego State secondary has done a great job in coverage, tight windows, and they've tackled well in space. The whole team, defensive side of the ball, has tackled well. Not a lot of missed tackles. They're keeping the ball in front of them. And that was one of the big challenges that Rocky Long had for his defense.
Well, the Aztecs decided not to use that timeout, so they let the time tick off the clock, and the first half comes to an end. A Rocky Long kind of first half. He told us yesterday, I'd love for this to be a 10-7 kind of game. How's 7-7? You think that's good enough?
Wishes do come true, Coach. See if you keep it up for another half.
Well, Tim DeRuiter and his team, who are one of the most potent offenses in college football, they have been slowed down by Rocky Long and the Aztecs. San Diego State's head coach standing by with Allison Williams.
Coach Long, how have you held Fresno State to just 7 points?
I think our kids are executing our game plan well, and the DBs are playing pretty good pass coverage.
How key has the pressure you've been able to get on Carr been?
Well, anytime you're able to get pressure on a great quarterback, it makes it a little bit harder on them, and I don't know how we're getting it, but we are getting pressure.
All right, tied up 7-7 at the half. What's your message to these guys?
That they'll make their adjustments. They're great coaches on that staff. They've got great players. They'll make some adjustments to take away what we're trying to do, and we're going to have to be ready to adjust on the sideline.
Thanks, Coach Long.
Thank you.
He's been around a while. He's got his kids playing well. San Diego State, Fresno State tied at 7. It's halftime. Now we'll join the studio with the BMW halftime report. It's the start of the second half here in San Diego, and a much different game than we expected. Fresno State, San Diego State tied at 7. Dave Fleming, David Diaz, Infante. This Fresno State team came in averaging 45 points a game, averaging 550 yards a game. What's happened to the Bulldogs offense?
What's happened is Rocky Long and San Diego State's high-pressure defense. They've kept that high-flying offense, Derek Carr and that trio of wide receivers, in check by pressuring the quarterback. 30% on third downs. They haven't been able to extend any drives, but Rocky Long, given 16 days to prepare for someone, they've done a great job of mixing up their pressure packages, 4-, 5-, and 6-man pressures to rattle, hit, and pressure Derek Carr. And their secondary has done a great job in the back half of covering things up. And you'll see Schramm and Carr right there trying to crack the code of the San Diego State defense.
Trying to figure out a way. Rocky Long and company played so well in that first half on the defensive side of the ball. They forced 4 punts. Fresno State had just over 100 yards of total offense. David Carr, 98 yards on 30 attempts. So the Bulldogs just could not get it going through the air. And that is their bread and butter. So we'll have to wait and see what kind of adjustments the Bulldogs make, but it's going to be fascinating to see.
Well, think about what Derek Carr, the numbers he's put up through 6 games this year, and their big play receiver, Davante Adams, one of the top duos in college football. Davante Adams, you know, he's been pretty much unstoppable the last 2 weeks, 407 yards, 7 touchdowns, and he barely has done anything this first half of play.
So Derek Carr and company, the younger brother of the Fresno State great quarterback David Carr, will have the ball to start this second half. Before that, though, let's go down once again to Allison Williams.
Dave, I asked Coach DeRuiter what plagued his offense in the first half, and it's exactly what you guys are talking about, pressure on the quarterback. He pointed out San Diego State had 2 weeks to prepare for this game, and it should. They are turning guys loose. So he said what's happening is Derek Carr is starting to not trust the protection, so they have to be better on their assignments. Guys are open. They just need some time back there. I asked him his message at the half. He said, I told my guys, we've been in this situation before in close games. If you want to win championships, you have to win on the road.
Just by far the poorest offensive half Fresno State has had all year. The handoff, Quezada, and he gets 3, maybe 4 on first down. The ground game was basically non-existent.
Yeah, and I think they've got to get something going there, because the answer for Fresno State can't be protection. They don't use a tight end. They're 4 wide receivers.
Quick tempo, and we'll see if that can help Fresno State get it going. Of Adams, what a move. Broke a couple different tackles. There is a penalty flag. And back sort of where the play started, so we'll see.
Could be holding one of those wide receivers on the perimeter in that bubble game. One of the few missed tackles we've seen by San Diego State, and there's probably a reason for it. We'll see if it was holding.
Fresno State only penalized once in the first half.
Block in the back. Offense number 10. 10-yard penalty. Still second down.
That's exactly what it was.
And you'll see number 10, Greg Watson, right there blocking in the back. Boy, he wasn't even going to make that tackle. Hands got to go up, stay off the defender.
There was no nuance about that call either. That was about as clear as it gets, the block in the back. So the penalty negates the gain and puts Fresno State back at the 15-yard line for 2nd and 16. Derek Carr in the shotgun. He throws quickly, incomplete, off the hands of Isaiah Burse. It's 3rd down. Remember, this is a Fresno State team, David, that is 17th in the BCS standings, undefeated, thinking that if they run the table, they're going to make that automatic berth into the BCS. And yet they are in for a battle here tonight.
Yeah, they're averaging over 45 points a game on the top functioning offenses in the country. But the San Diego State team, you can see the pressure building. That's a pass they don't normally drop. You know, they don't make those missed assignments, those drops, those missed timed elements part of their offense.
Carr on third down. Rushing just three, still pressured. He's going to throw it deep. Harper down there. The pass is deflected, incomplete. Good defense again. This time, J.J. Whitaker knocked it away.
Great job by J.J. Whitaker. They play coverage in the back end. They only rush three. Look at Whitaker find the ball, play the ball in the air, and keep their big play receiver, Josh Harper, from making that catch.
This will be the fifth Fresno State punt of this game, the third time they've had a three and out. So trying to get some things figured out at halftime, and Derek Carr and company still have a lot of work to do. Garrett Swanson has had to work hard, pressured here. Gets off another pretty good punt, a little shorter, and a fair catch signal at the 45, 39-yard punt. No return, good field position for the Aztecs. When we come back, a 7-7 game.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the WatchESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Halloween's pretty big in this town. We're just a few days away, and they're getting ready in San Diego in the Gas Lamp District. We're here tonight at Qualcomm Stadium. San Diego State is homecoming for the Aztecs, hosting a top 20 team, 17th-ranked undefeated Fresno State, and holding their own, and maybe a little more than that. 7-7, just about a minute into the third quarter. Muema, the tailback, with the carry and a gain of 3 yards. Another quick update along the sidelines with Allison Williams.
Yeah, Dave, this Fresno State offense may be slowed right now, but their confidence is not shaken. Derek Carr came off the field very relaxed. He told his guys, hey, we're good. We were good until that penalty. They can't stop us, so we can't beat ourselves.
All right, thanks. So that is the quality they talk about with Derek Carr. Cool, calm, under pressure, a great leader.
Well, you look at his demeanor there. He doesn't look rattled at all. They've been in close games, but they've been 50-point close games. 52-51 overtime against Rutgers, and then 41-40 against Boise State.
Look at that run by Adam Uema, breaking tackles, dragging several defensive players with him, and he gets 6 yards and gets very close to a first down.
And that's the guy the San Diego State needs Moema to be, the downhill physical punishing runner. Again, tough yards inside, because they're pounding away at the middle of that defense. Then you bring Pumphrey in as your change of pace guy and perimeter run guy.
Quick to the line, and then the big shift.
Unbalanced
on the left side, and they'll fake it to Moema. The quarterback throws downfield, and it's incomplete. Intended for Robert Craighead, the tight end. So on third and very short, they go through the air, and it's incomplete.
Well, they went for that there. You'll see they've got the fake. Look, the fullbacks open the flat. Take the sure thing. You don't have to go for the bigger throw down the field. Take the conversion. But I think that's also an easy call. And I thought maybe they were going to go for it on fourth down, but they're going to decide to punt.
Well, Rocky Long loves to go for it on fourth down, and I am surprised he's not doing it here. His defense is playing very well. Joel Alisi, the punter, will kick it away. That was a huge mistake. The first down was there to be had, and they just didn't take it. The punt's going to go into the end zone, and that sequence just did not work out well for the Aztecs. Bulldogs are getting the ball back at the 20-yard line. Now, Rocky Long won't be happy about that. 7-7 is the score. This Mountain West Conference, Fresno State, the headline team right now. They beat Boise State, so the signature win of the conference, but both of these teams are still undefeated in league play.
Absolutely. The winner of this game takes a huge step forward. Fresno State, obviously everyone thinking in the driver's seat for the conference and the BCS busting type opportunity. But hey, San Diego State's right there. They're well positioned. Look at UNLV right there, 3-1. And San Jose State, 2-1 still in Mountain West Conference play.
A wild game, the Spartans at home. Your Spartans against Wyoming. Today, San Jose State with David Fales, excellent quarterback. Quick pass burst with the completion. Tried to get to the corner, and he did, but there just wasn't a whole lot of room there. Shoved out of bounds. He got maybe 2 yards, three on first down.
All week, these defensive backs of San Diego State, Pinkins, Holder, and Whitaker, have talked about how physical they need to be against this bubble screen game of Fresno State.
Here's the handoff, Martez Waller, and Waller powers his way for a first down across the 30, out toward the 32.
Even these spread offenses, you have to have some element and a piece of your run game as a part of your offense. And here is Waller again, tough physical running away from the action. You've got to try and run the ball to settle things down for your offense.
Well, the officials stopped the clock, and Tim DeRuiter is not happy. He was trying to go quick tempo there after the first down, and that stoppage helped San Diego State get a little better organized on defense.
That's right, and they got a substitution in there as well.
Now Tim DeRuiter is trying to say, you can't do that. Derek Carr comes to the line. First and 10 Bulldogs.
Showing pressure. Derek Carr is checking the protection.
Carr rolling to his right. Downfield. Throws. Harper is out of bounds, and the ball is thrown way out of bounds. Incomplete.
You'll see the pressure coming right up the middle. These linebackers coming here and there. They're going to get pressure right in Derek's face. Here it comes. And you'll see him come right up the gut. Derek Carr escapes the pressure, but again, he's forced to throw the ball out of bounds down the field.
So second and 10 for Fresno State. The play fake. Carr just doesn't have anywhere to go with the ball, and he's going to be dragged down. Nick Tanoff with the sack.
And you'll see number 36 on your screen. Again, he's not fooled by the play action fake. He stays on Derek Carr and finishes the job for another sack for San Diego State.
This time a loss of 14 yards. Nick Tanoff playing very well. The Aztecs say he may play harder than anybody they have on defense. Third and 24, a little dump pass short. It is complete. It gets positive yards, but it's going to come up way short of the first down. They needed another 9 yards or so. Waller got 15. They needed 24. And I think we're going to see another Fresno State punt.
Yeah, this is uncharted territory for this Fresno State offense so far this season. And you'll see that 37 attempts. Look, hits, Harries, and sacks. It's all taking its toll on this offense.
So there has got to be some level of frustration for the Bulldogs. Cool and calm, Derek Carr. But things are not going well for a team that has hopes of playing in a BCS bowl game this year. But if they lose this game, those hopes will be dashed. That's just the way it works. The punt by Swanson. And a fair catch inside the 20 will send us to another timeout.
Yeah, you'll see Nick Tanoff at San Diego State continues to pressure Fresno State. And they're all tied up, 7 apiece.
Let's take a look at our FaceTime profile brought to you by Edward Jones, the Carr brothers. David, the older brother, one of the all-time greats. Derek Carr is certainly that at Fresno State. You see the huge passing numbers in their Bulldogs career. When Derek was a little kid, a huge fan of his older brother when he was at the helm of the Bulldogs. Let's take a listen. Well, he was a pretty confident kid. What was he, 11 years old there? And talking about David Carr, his older brother, who was the number one overall draft pick in the NFL and had a long NFL career. Hand off Adam Muema. Power running for Muema. Knocked the defender Ellis down. And he got 8 yards or so on first down. The Aztecs giving Derek Carr and Fresno State a heck of a game here tonight. 7-7. Right around 5 minutes or so into this second half. And Muema's starting to get some things going on the ground.
Yeah, he is. And, you know, he's the hammer part of this offense. They'll switch off between the two guys. They've got the hammer, and then they've got the speed in Pumphrey.
And they get the speed in there. Pumphrey's going to take the pitch play coming right side. Cuts back, trying to get away, and he loses yardage. So that ends up going backwards by a yard or two.
And you'll see the white jerseys of Fresno State. Just a quick pitch outside. They're trying to outflank him. Crack back, get some lead blockers in front, but watch the pursuit of that defense of Fresno State. Lots of white jerseys hammering the football.
It was second and a long one. Now it's third and 3. So that was a damaging second down play.
That changes everything, huh?
It does. And Quinn Taylor missed a pretty easy throw, it looked like, on fourth down the last time the Aztecs had the ball. Or on third down, forced a fourth down, under center here on third and 3. throwing middle, and he's got his man caught for a first down, the tight end Adam Roberts. So a real good throw there.
And you'll see the pressure right up front here. They're going to come here and here and get to him. Watch San Diego State pick it up, give their quarterback time to see his tight end right over the middle to pick up the first down.
Now the right guard, Darrell Green, number 72, he made one big block and ended up picking off another pass rusher, so he blocked two at once. Helped make that play. Kaler steps up. He's got his tight end Roberts again. Left side, first down. Out near the 45. He actually stepped out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. But 11 yards and a first down gain for the Aztecs.
I tell you, Quinn Kaler's done a nice job on third down. You see quick timing throws here. He's going to find his tight end again. Look at him hitch. He knows pressure's coming, but he's finding a way to deliver the ball down the field on crucial situations for San Diego State.
So first down, Aztecs starting to move the ball again. Ruffin, who had the big game in the first half as a receiver, went in motion. A handoff to Muema. He tripped and got back to the line of scrimmage no more. Clock continues to move. That's part of the Aztecs game plan. Try to shorten the game. Give the Bulldogs fewer chances, keep them out of the rhythm, and that certainly has worked. Bob Toledo, their offensive coordinator, calling a play on second and 10. Kaler, the play fake, pressured, and he throws incomplete. Now the safety, Ron Smith, made a break on the ball. All-American candidate, and that one had stayed up just a half second more. He might have had one.
Well, now it's Fresno State. They're a high-pressure defense, too, and they bring two off that right edge of the offense, you know, thinking that they're going to try and roll out their quarterback to the right. Well-timed, well-played to force the errant throw. There's Nick Toth, defensive coordinator. He believes in pressure, pressure, pressure. And when you have high-scoring offense, it allows you those liberties to take chances defensively.
And maybe a different idea tonight just because of the way this game is going. Kaler steps up. He's going to throw, and he's got his man caught for a first down. Into Fresno State territory. Heck of a throw, and another catch for Izzell Ruffin.
Well, Ruffin's been his man, big play guy for them offensively, and especially on third down. You'll see Ruffin right here. He's going to drive in a defensive back and just bend it right in front of him. Knows where the sticks are. Great awareness of making sure he got the proper depth to pick up the first down.
Six catches, 126 yards for Izzell Ruffin. So he's been the main weapon in the pass game for the Aztecs. Kaler back to pass again, looking right side. Ruffin jumps up, and he caught another one. What a game this guy is having, the junior from Long Beach.
A look at the look on his face. That guy is balling right now. Do you see him? He's one-on-one. He knows it. A great throw by Kaler to give his playmaker a chance to fight for the ball in the air. Look, everyone's been talking about Fresno State's receivers, Burse, Harper, and Adams. He says, I've got game of my own. And he is dominating this football game so far.
It's not quite first and goal at the 11. Career high, 160 yards for Ruffin now. Kaler under center, handoff. We'll have a good cut to the left side. Still on his feet, down to around the six for the Aztecs, who with the score will go ahead in this game. That was a 5-yard run on first down.
Hey, credit that offensive line for San Diego State. They're healthy, been playing together more. Coach says, hey, I feel like we're getting better. That's what allowed Ruffin and their quarterback, Quinn Kaler, to get on the same page and create some big plays. They're running the ball effectively, and they've done a decent job in protecting their quarterback.
Ruffin's got more receiving yards himself than Fresno State has total yards of offense in this game. Amazing. Now on second down and 5 from the 6. 10th play of the drive here. Under center, Kaler. He's going to pitch it. Muema looking for a block. He gets a block. Stiff arm, stays on his feet, and stopped just short of the goal line. There's your fullback again, Chad Young, with the lead block and then tough running from Muema.
Yeah, Muema knows what to do after and follow the block of Chad Young. Knee is down before he crosses the plane. Good spot by the officials, but look at the effort. The San Diego State team is fighting. They are fighting hard here tonight. They are hungry.
Now Bouema took the helmet right off Kyrie Wilson, so he's got to come out of the game for this first and goal play. Aztecs knocking on the door. Bouema, left side, touchdown San Diego State. Their first lead of the game. And the Bulldogs are officially on upset alert tonight.
And that's the way to finish off a drive. Physical nature. Offensive line doing it. Fullback Chad Young running the football hard.
Extra point coming here. 11 plays, 80 yards. Bouema's second touchdown of the game. The Aztecs with a 14-7 lead with 5:45 to go in the third quarter. First, it was Ruffin in the pass game with the big play down the field. And then Bouema capitalized into the end zone. 14-7 Aztecs.
ESPN College Football Finale, brought to you by Progressive. Comparing rates to help you save. Now that's Progressive. And American Blackout on the National Geographic Channel.
It is homecoming tonight at San Diego State. So the festivities at halftime, and the Aztecs are putting on a show at homecoming. Kickoff, San Diego State with its first lead of the game over number 17 Fresno State. Kick return across the 25, but a late penalty flag. Dylan Root with the return of 21 yards, but we'll see what the penalty is. On the return, the Bulldogs, 17th ranked team in the country in the BCS standings, undefeated, a chance to move into an automatic spot with an undefeated season, and yet being really tested here tonight in conference.
On the return, holding, receiving team, number 41, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Well, you could understand there's some anxiety on the Fresno State sideline. The head coach, Tim DeRuiter, look at the numbers. The powerful Bulldogs offense has just been stymied.
Yeah, absolutely, and you have to take your hat off to San Diego State and their plan and how they prepared during their bye week. They have done it in the back end, covering those big-time wide receivers of Fresno State, and then by pressuring Derek Carr.
Averaging 45 points and 555 yards a game. They have 7 points and just over 100 yards. Waller tackled after a gain of 2. And that counts these minutes as positive yardage for the Bulldogs offense. They have just had nowhere to go. Last 24 plays, a total of 38 yards.
Wow, and talking to Rocky Long the other day, he's saying, hey, we just need to get a couple stops somewhere and try to keep up with them. Well, they've done just that, like 7 stops in the game.
They've done a lot more than that. And this is a Rocky Long, San Diego State style football game. Derek Carr, pass is caught. Nice catch. Adams had to reach down to grab it to set up a third and short.
You know, and all the talk as long is about Fresno State, this high scoring offense. He goes, hey, they may have a few more athletes than we have, but we got some tough, scrappy guys ourselves, too. And I tell you what, they're displaying that toughness here tonight.
Third and 3. They spotted him out of bounds, well short of that first down. Devontae Adams, a car in the shotgun. 5 receivers, nobody in the backfield with him.
And no safety in the middle of the field. They're showing pressure.
A little sprint right. He's going to throw middle of the field, intended for burst, and 2 flags are thrown. There was some contact there. Aztecs fans don't like it. Nat Burhe, the standout safety, is going to be called for a penalty. And you pointed it out right at the snap. There just was no extra help there in the middle of the field.
Yeah, and they jumped the bubble screen, and they're trying to hit burst down the field on the go.
Rocky Long not happy about it. The officiating crew, Kevin Marr, is the head referee. Just trying to sort this one out. We'll get the call.
Pass interference. Defense number 20. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
7th penalty against San Diego State, so that has been a problem.
Burhe again, you'll see him against number 1, burst right there down the field. Boy, that is some touchy contact right there.
And there wasn't a lot of contact. I will say, I think he stopped the momentum of burst going down after the ball.
Restricting the receiver is one thing they'll look for.
But you're right, there wasn't a lot of contact there, and the Bulldogs may have gotten a break. Derek Carr in the pocket, throws short, caught. Adams breaks a tackle to the 40, into the sideline, across the 40, knocked out of bounds. All that effort, and he gets maybe 6 yards. Burhey with the tackle.
Burhey there to make the tackle. He misses it, and that's one of the few missed tackles they have. Look, they're dragging him across. Burhey's going to pick him up. He's there to make the play. Can't finish the tackle, though. That's one of the few times they haven't done that.
Second and 6. They actually spotted him just 4 yards. Burse, quick catch, turns it upfield. That speed. And Isaiah Burse with the first down. So 8-yard gain for Burse and the Bulldogs. That is a Fresno State first down. Nearing midfield, down by 7 points in an unfamiliar position. The 17th ranked team in the country. Trying to pick up some tempo. Carr pressured again. Flushed, he's going to throw it away. Incomplete. Amazing how over and over again San Diego State is putting pressure on Derek Carr.
Josh Gabbard again, I think he's going to come from here to bring pressure on the quarterback. They are guessing right with their blitz packages. He's going to scrape over the top of his defensive lineman, creating a pick inside. Gets there, forces the errant throw once again.
Well, Gabbard and Nick Tenhoff, two of the Aztecs linebackers, they have just played so well in this game. Second and 10 for the Bulldogs. Play clock down to 3. Carr throws, going deep again. Burse can't catch up with it. Burhey again with the coverage.
And I think the pressure is getting to Derek Carr. You get hit along enough, you get pressured enough, it affects your accuracy. These are plays and throws that this team has made so far through the first 6 games of this season. Not making them here tonight yet.
He's 20 for 40. In 40 attempts, he's got 132 yards passing. Third and 10. And a big play here as the third quarter starts to wind down. Carr, quick release, and the pass is caught by Adams, and he's got the first down. Great throw, maybe the best of the game for Derek Carr, and Devontae Adams did the rest.
Yeah, again, Carr knows his pressure coming. They're playing games with the line of scrimmage, and he's going to get the ball to his big-time wide receiver, make the catch for the conversion.
So 13 yards into Aztecs territory, a big conversion for Fresno State. Giving some instructions to that right side, and they'll throw it quickly right. It's Watson looking for somewhere to go, and really nowhere to go. He went backwards by a half yard. Devontae Casey, who is a redshirt freshman, the younger brother of a running back at San Diego State, Walter Casey, who's a really good player. They think younger bro is going to be a good one too.
Well, they are, and you'll see those defensive backs of San Diego State attacking the perimeter, those bubble screens and slip screens outside. You've got to out physical as wide receivers and make those plays, and they're doing it so far tonight.
Yeah, we heard Rocky Long tell that to Allison at halftime. He thought that was a big key in the game so far. Burse with the catch, tackled short of the first down at about the 31-yard line, so they need 2 more. That's a gain of 9.
Uncovered wide receiver in the slot by San Diego State. Derek Carr finds it and hits it quickly. No wasted motion. The rush can't get there. Excellent job of identifying that receiver by Derek Carr.
So 3rd and 2. Could be 4 down territory for the Bulldogs. Running back is Quezada. They'll give it to Josh Quezada. He's got the first down and more. Still on his feet. Into the secondary. 15 and down to the 10. What a run for the BYU transfer. Josh Quezada, 20 yards.
When you start paying so much attention to the perimeter and that bubble and slip screen game outside, it's easy to over-pursue the running back when they sneak in a handoff to him. And that's what happened to the San Diego State defense again. Break tackles, missed tackles. Now they're inside the 10.
Carr on first down toward the end zone. Jump ball caught. Touchdown. Devontae Adams. Another one for Adams, his 12th of the year. And the Bulldogs are an extra point away from tying the game.
They get the matchup they want outside, man-to-man coverage. Davante Adams at 6'2" is going to elevate and make the play over the shorter defensive back, David Lamar, for the touchdown. Was his left foot out of bounds?
Very close.
That again.
I think the right foot was down first.
Yes.
I think the right foot was down first. The extra point with Colin McGuire is up, and it is good. And what a drive at the right time for Fresno State. The pressure on. 11 plays, 85 yards, and the touchdown.
Gut check time for this Fresno State offense. Derek Carr and Davante Adams come through, and they go up for this game right now.
Well, Fresno State, with all their big goals and dreams for this 2013 season, undefeated, being tested here, but an answer on that drive to tie the game.
Look, they played in some close games this year, but high-scoring, tough games right now. Now they find themselves in a back-alley brawl. They're going toe-to-toe with the pesky, tough, physical San Diego State football team. It has a totally different kind of feel, and we're going to find out a lot about this Fresno State Bulldog team here tonight.
A 76-yard touchdown drive. Davante Adams, who had 7 touchdown catches in the last 2 weeks. Gets one here tonight.
Over 400 yards. I mean, he's been a one-man wrecking crew outside, defeating man-to-man coverage. Hats off to the secondary of San Diego State to keep him in check so far in this game.
So the Bulldogs have tied the game up. Aztecs are going to get the ball back, and still a long way to go. A minute 50 left in quarter number 3. Fresno State will kick the ball. Deep to receive. It's Colin Lockett for the Aztecs. And he gets a hold. 25-30. Lockett's got great speed across the 40 and tripped up near the 45-yard line. So the Aztecs get a little boost in the kick return game.
Well, Colin Lockett's a guy that gets it done for that in special teams as well. He's had 3 kickoff returns for touchdowns since 2011. He gets close there, but gives them great field position to start this drive after Fresno State answered their touchdown.
Yeah, they'll call it a 44-yard kickoff return. So the Aztecs offense, which itself has gotten into a nice rhythm as this game has gone on, back with the ball. They walk on quarterback Quinn Kaler, who has just become a great story for San Diego State, under center. He's helped change this Aztecs team. Hand off Pumphrey, the freshman. And just a yard, maybe 2. So Donnell Pumphrey, the true freshman, who's had some big plays in this game. But Fresno State's done a decent job. He's been huge the last 3 weeks. A bunch of big plays on the ground. He's been a little quieter here tonight.
Well, Fresno State has two safeties deep in the secondary. You've got to be able to run the football if you're San Diego State.
High formation with that excellent fullback Young. They will hand it off again. Pumphrey squirts through. Pumphrey across midfield, short of the first down, but only by a couple of yards. And they gave San Diego State just a very poor spot. They moved him way back. So I thought he was about a yard short. It's 3rd and 3, though, for the Aztecs.
And that's Pumphrey hitting it up right between the tackles. There's some blocking and some hitting taking place.
Kaler in the shotgun. And he's going to give it to Pumphrey. Tries to make a move, and there's nothing there. The big tackle by Fresno State. Excellent play. And I think the Aztecs are going to have to give the ball back, but we'll see. That was Charles Washington in run coverage.
Charles Washington came flying up on the play before, missed the tackle. This time he is there and secures the tackle and does it with a little attitude too.
Well, we'll see what the Aztecs decide to do. The third quarter comes to an end, so we'll go to quarter number 4, and we've got a heck of a game. The Bulldogs and their standout quarterback Derek Carr with BCS dreams, but really being tested, tied with San Diego State 14-14.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Beautiful night in San Diego and a heck of a game. The Aztecs are really pushing number 17 undefeated Fresno State. Tie game as the fourth quarter begins, and Joel Alisi with a high punt bursts with the fair catch signal, and he'll make the fair catch inside the 10-yard line. Only four races left. The chase for the Sprint Cup hits the home stretch. Jimmy Johnson, Matt Kenseth lead the chase field into historic Martinsville Speedway NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Martinsville Sunday at 1 Eastern on ESPN. So a 40-yard punt. Fresno State's defense with a big stop. Bulldogs went down the field, scored the tying touchdown last time they had the ball.
Well, it's just too bad San Diego State couldn't take advantage of the field position they had, the short field.
After the big kickoff return, Carr dumps it off short left. The big hit and the immediate tackle. The running back Waller made the catch, but basically no gain.
Cody Gallia again coming off the edge in Derek Carr's face. He gets the open receiver in the flat, but then there is San Diego State to make the tackle.
Good play by Eric Pinkins with the wrap up. Second and 10 Bulldogs. Carr throws short, Burns with the catch, turns it upfield. He's got the first down. And a little breathing room for Fresno State.
Again, Burns is becoming a target as they go up tempo here.
Something they've just not had much opportunity to do in this game. Adams with the quick catch and the gain across the 25 out to about the 26. Four, maybe 5 yards. We'll see if Fresno State continues that quick tempo. Ball plays down. Carr moves Martez Waller to his right side. And taking a little longer this time. Middle. Adams, nice catch with the strong hands for a first down. You can see the tools of Devontae Adams even on short play like that.
And there they are, just a little spacing right. They're going to threaten the flat defender. Look at Devontae Adams find the soft spot in the coverage.
Carr is starting to get on a bit of a roll. He's completed 8 straight passes. Not going downfield much. This time the ball is batted and incomplete. He took a hit and the ball was knocked down. Dontrell Anuoha, who got his first start here tonight, knocked the ball down.
Well, and you'll see the pressure too. He's going to take this one in the chops again. It's number 48, Josh Gabbert. And now they get the hands up in the line of scrimmage. That's just as good as a sack. He hit the quarterback, knocked down the ball.
Second and 10, Carr, handoff, Waller up the middle for a big gain across the 40. A flag thrown, though, behind the play, and that may well negate what was an 11-yard carry. The official talking with Derek Carr about what the call is.
Holding, offense number 73, 10-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Cody Wickman, the junior, who went to the same high school as an all-time Fresno State great, Logan Mankins.
Logan Mankins, what a great offensive guard. He's been all pro, pro bowler every year for the New England Patriots. Well, that guy's a stud.
Wickman, who, that's his role model, but that a penalty that negates a big gain and moves Fresno State well back.
Well, it's just too bad because they caught San Diego State bailing out from showing blitz, so it creates some softness in that defensive front of theirs, and they're able to exploit it, but the holding penalty took that away.
Carr, quick release, burst with the catch, made the first man miss, but a short gain on second and long, forced out of bounds right around the 25-yard line. Third down and very long coming up.
Suluono had a chance. He was beelining for burst outside, attacking that bubble. We'll see if Fresno State right now, as much as San Diego State's attacking that bubble screen and those slip screens, if they got a chance to go for the bubble and go, or slip and go. Something downfield to take advantage of the aggressive nature of San Diego State.
So third and 17 for Derek Carr and company. Tie game into the fourth quarter. Carr has some time this time. He'll throw deep middle, and he's got his man at midfield. Harper still on the move. Inside the 30, another missed tackle to the 25-yard line. Josh Harper, 50 yards, first down, Fresno State. What a huge play in this game. And the Bulldogs want to run another one very quickly. And the whistle is blown. Penalty flag on the field. They got to the line so quickly. San Diego State had extra guys running onto the field.
Offside. Defense number 55. 5-yard penalty. First down.
They caught him up tempo, substituting. That's what good up tempo teams do. After a big play, how fast can you get to the line of scrimmage? Great job by Fresno State.
So first and five for the Bulldogs, trying to go back ahead in this game. Carr ran forward, then throws. Burse breaks a tackle, now comes back all the way to the other side, to the middle, dives forward, and he got 4 yards when it looked like there was absolutely nothing there.
Again, they go four wide receivers in like a diamond formation outside of the numbers, trying to isolate Burse and get him some room with some blockers in front of him.
Carr made a block himself on that play, second and one.
Yeah, I'd love to see that from your quarterback. That means he's all in.
Teammates love to see it. The head coach, offensive coordinator, maybe don't love it quite so much. Carr lob, Adams caught, touchdown. What a catch. Another one for Devonte Adams. Fresno State back in front. He is one of the best wide receivers in the country, and he's showing why.
Watch the touch off his back leg by Derek Carr, putting a great touch on the ball for Devonte Adams to high point the football. He is in. That's a touchdown. He takes advantage of the shorter King Holder.
His second of the game, and that one was pretty spectacular. His quarterback is pumped up about it. His 13th touchdown of the season. 91 yards into the end zone. Bulldogs back in front. It's 21-14 Fresno State.
Again, it's Derek Carr to Devonte Adams. Look, they're fired up as they go up 21-14 Fresno State.
Saturday, it's an ACC showdown with BCS title implications on the line as the Miami Hurricanes take on the Florida State Seminoles in one of college football's most heated rivalries. Miami, Florida State, Saturday, 8 Eastern on ABC.
Well, that will be a tough one for the Hurricanes on the road, the way Florida State is playing. Fresno State down 14-7, but two touchdowns in a row for Derek Carr and the Bulldogs. And Fresno State is back in front on the road against the Aztecs. Kicking the ball away. And it's a short squib style kick, bobbled initially. But now the move to the left side, to the 45, the big man midfield and into Bulldogs territory. My goodness, that is not how that's supposed to work. That squib kick supposed to prevent the big return. Instead, the big guy, Everett Beat, a defensive lineman with the return.
Having visions of being a high school running back or athlete, the big man takes it around the corner, and the pooch kick backfires on Fresno State. Suddenly now momentum shifts back to San Diego State. See if they get something with the ball and take advantage of good field position.
Well, that's pretty incredible, and Tim DeRuiter cannot be happy about it. Well, the Aztecs into Bulldogs territory before they run a play. Down 7, 11:30 to go against the 17th ranked undefeated Bulldogs. Handed off right side, Pumphrey hit in the backfield and dropped. Well, Pumphrey just no running room, the true freshman. Curtis Riley got in on the play. It's a loss of a yard.
This is Quinn Kaler. They got edge pressure. Look, they got pressure coming right here. He's got to get him out of that play. They've got too many guys coming there. The corner's going to fire late and beat the wide receiver to attack that side of the offensive running attack.
Second and 11. Aztecs in the shotgun. Kaler, time, caught. That's Ruffin. Bulldogs have quieted him down the last maybe half a quarter or so. It's been a big game for him. 5 yards. That's his 8th catch of the game. He's got 165 yards through the air.
He has done the damage for San Diego State against that Fresno State defense. He showed some real toughness, physical, yards after the catch as well.
So third down coming up, third and about six for the Aztecs. Ruffin in motion. Taylor is going to sprint left and throws, and he's got his man, and it's dropped by Ruffin. For all the great plays he's made, he had that one, and it's dropped. Incomplete. It's fourth down.
Wow, he's made so many clutch catches here tonight. Again, Quinn Kaler's going to put the ball out there. He just can't get both hands back around to the back side of it. That's what happens when you roll a right-handed quarterback out to the left side. Unless you square your shoulders up, it's hard to be accurate with the football.
And Ezell Ruffin knows that that was a missed opportunity. Aztecs are going for it. Just over 10 minutes to go, fourth and six. Down by a touchdown. Kaler, the pressure, throws, and it's caught for a first down. Ruffin inside the 25. The ball was stripped away there at the end of the play. And Fresno State thinks they have the ball. Ezell Ruffin with another big catch. They have not blown the play dead. And the Bulldogs do have the ball. It's at Arene. Still going. And are they going to call this a touchdown? They do. Unbelievable. Everybody basically stopped. And Arene came out of there with the ball, and he didn't stop. Ended up returning it 79 yards for a touchdown when it looked like the fourth down play was a first down for the Aztecs. But the officials say Ruffin was, and I guess it is.
On the field is a fumble and a touchdown.
I mean, he definitely fumbled the ball. Watching that replay, the ball was coming out, and they never blew the whistle. Everybody stopped playing, but that ball was coming loose.
Wow, it was. We'll see. And again, ruled a fumble on the field. The ball was not blown dead. The ball is out. Ruffin thinks he is down. Heads up play.
Ederain almost ran out of bounds there. It's not that heads up when you almost run out of bounds. And he was dancing and celebrating. Finally realized the whistle hadn't blown. And he just took off and kept going. So that did not look good all the way around. Finally, Adriel Ederaine got the idea that the play was not dead, and then he took off. And we'll watch it again, but that ball's coming out. There's no question that's a fumble.
That ball is out. It is a fumble. Ruffin fighting for extra yards. He had the fourth down conversion, just didn't maintain possession of the football. And that ball is out. Looks like the knee of Ederaine causes that fumble.
Well, just a totally bizarre play. Ruffin, meanwhile, was trying to say that he was down, but I just don't know how you could say that he was down. The ball was coming out.
I thought he was down at first, too, until we looked at that replay. Because I think partly because the reaction of the players around the ball, everything kind of just stopped.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Fumble and a touchdown, Fresno State.
Amazing. Adriel Ederaine picked the ball up. Really, even himself didn't know what was going on. Started to celebrate the play. Finally took off, and he took it 79 yards for a touchdown. Extra point up, and it is good. It is 28-14 Fresno State.
How quickly things can change as San Diego State converts on third down. The fumble by Ruffin and the recovery by Ederaine goes 79 yards for the touchdown to put Fresno State up 28-14.
Unbelievable.
ESPN College Football Finale, brought to you by USAA, proudly serving the financial needs of current and former military members and their families.
Spectacular night in San Diego along the harbor. We're at Qualcomm Stadium. Fresno State down 14-7, 21 unanswered points, though, the last seven on defense. Adriel Ederaine with the 79-yard return after a fumble on a disputed play. A fourth down conversion looked like a huge play for the Aztecs, going in for the game tying touchdown instead. 7 points the other way, and the big play guy on defense. They'll try another squib kick. We'll see if it works a little bit better. And it works better, but it still doesn't work all that well. Well, Adro, the sophomore, even he was a little confused about what was going on. Let's listen during that timeout.
Hey, I thought it was down. I thought it was good.
Yeah, good play anyway. We knew you thought it was down. He literally almost walked out of bounds. He got lucky in that his foot didn't step on the sideline, then realized the play had never been blown dead, and went to the end zone. 28-14, and here's a catch for a gain. No, they say incompletion. Let's get a little more on that bizarre play with Allison Williams.
Well, it was just funny to watch the reaction down here on the Fresno State sideline. Edirene was going nuts. All of his teammates were going nuts. The only guy that was pretty calm, Derek Carr, he still wants more. He said, hey, man, great play, but go out there and get the ball back again. We can't stop now.
Well, his head coach has given him a hug. That's a game-changing play and just totally bizarre, wild. But definitely in favor of the Bulldogs. Kaler back to pass, throws, and the ball is tipped up and incomplete. There was a chance there. That ball was in the air. Nico Mata thought he had a chance to pick it off.
You see Quinn Kaler again. There's that big paw getting up there by Nico Mata.
Third and 10, Aztecs. Still 9:37 to go in this game. I mean, that was a huge play. May end up looking back on it and saying it was the big play of the game, but there is a long way to go.
Again, turnovers have gone the way of Fresno State all season long, now forcing 14 on the season.
Third and 10, Kaler pressured, throws, and it is caught! Inside the 30, cutting it back middle, 20, 10, inside the 5, Tim Vizzy. 60 yards, it's first and goal, Aztecs. And indeed, this one's not over. Now we got the kind of game we thought we were going to have the whole way through.
You'll look at Vizzy right here. Look, his defender falls down. I don't know if that ball's going to Ruffin or Vizzy, but Vizzy snags it out of the air, stiff arms, and just comes up short of the end zone.
Lemard, he has a couple touchdowns rushing. He's the tailback, first and goal. And they're going to give it on a reverse kind of play toward the end zone. Touchdown. Touchdown, San Diego State. And Aaron Bosch with the touchdown run with the extra point pending.
And you see Bosch, just like the one that Pumphrey scored on in one of their games earlier this year, they're going to hide him. He's going to come around on the end around from the tight end in the wing position for the touchdown.
Well, that didn't take long, 57 seconds. And we got a wild one all of a sudden at Qualcomm. Extra point up and good, 28-21. Aztecs got a lot of life in this one. They are giving the 17th ranked Bulldogs a heck of a test. Well, celebrating its ninth year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kick. To date, Allstate has contributed more than $3.2 million in scholarship monies. Homecoming at San Diego State, and this game has gotten a lot crazier in the last few minutes. First 39 minutes combined, we had 14 points in this game. Last 12 minutes, 35. And we've seen them scored in a lot of different ways. The 17th ranked team in the country in those BCS standings. Fresno State with a 28-21 lead. San Diego State with an answer and a touchdown drive. Now the Aztecs will onside kick it, and it's going to work! Beautifully executed, and Vizzy, the guy who had the big gain in the pass game, came down with it. What a moment for the special teams of the Aztecs. San Diego State has the ball again.
I had a hunch that might be coming, but boy, they showed nothing and it was a little kind of pooch kick timed perfectly along the sideline. Look at this. The approach is normal, just a little flip up in the air. It's like he threw it to him. Tim Vizzy comes up big again for the Aztecs.
Wow, that's impressive. Seamus McMorrow, the kicker, just could not have done that better. And Vizzy was right there. And it was like he was a wide receiver all over again. It was a wobbly pass, if it was a pass.
Looked like a rugby kick pass sort of thing.
But into Bulldogs territory, first down. Adam Uwema, power runner, powers his way forward inside the 45 to the 44. 5 yard gain. Aztecs are just not going away in this game.
No, they are. They're showing some scrappiness themselves like they did all the first half. Now things have changed. Now they've handled the adversity, the big play, the swings of momentum, and now they created their own momentum changer with the onside kick and recovery. The key is, can you capitalize on it?
Ruffin in motion for the Aztecs. Hand off Uwema, stutter stepping his way through, and that's another example. There wasn't a whole lot there, and he gets some forward yardage, but only a couple to bring up third down.
And what a contrast in styles as San Diego State compacts the formation and runs power right behind it. And Moema doing a great job of finding the sliver between the blockers and the tacklers to pick up positive yards.
Bob Toledo, offensive coordinator, again, could be four down territory. It's third and three Aztecs. Taylor's been pretty good. The walk-on quarterback on third down plays. They'll hand it off. Uwema cut back left, now up the middle, lowers his shoulder, has the first down and more. Nice run for Adam Uwema. The junior is getting healthy again and starting to run like he did last year, 6 yards.
Watch Adam Uwema too. He's going to start out to the right, follow his fullback to the right side over here, and then cut back behind his blockers. Again, keeping it tight, hugging the line of scrimmage, and then getting north and south and running behind his pads and moving the pile forward.
A pretty decisive run from Uwema there to make sure they got the first down. Inside the 40. First and 10, San Diego State. And a pass caught by Ruffin. Pitch back play along the sideline. Knocked out of bounds. Another wrinkle. It was Pumphrey, the running back, who came over and took the lateral. And the Aztecs end up where they're going to spot the ball.
Exciting offense comes in all sorts of form and fashion. There's Ruffin lateraling to Pumphrey again outside for a nice chunk of yardage, creating some offense, good blocking out in front, a little deception.
8 yards, and a pretty spectacular 8 yards at that.
Now watch him come right back now and hammer it right down the throat to that Fresno State defense.
Uwema, who got hammered, but pushes forward and close, but I don't think he got there. Kyrie Wilson with the initial push and hit the linebacker, number 17. It's going to be third down at about a yard.
Well, and that was fine because what's happened in the last couple short yardage situations for San Diego State, they end up losing yardage on that down, which kind of took away their ability, one, to go for it on fourth down or retain any kind of momentum. So positive yards, very important there on second down.
Big play. 6:20 to go. Hand off, fullback straight ahead run into the open. Chad Young, touchdown. 27 yards. An extra point away, San Diego State, from tying this game.
Watch Chad Young on the quick hitter. The tailback goes right, and there's Chad Young splitting the defense. Look, there's no one left in the middle of the field as Fresno State was crowding the line of scrimmage.
Well, the big extra point here, you got to convert on these. The kicking game has been very shaky for the Aztecs. McMorrow kick is up and good, and this game is tied.
Chad Young usually does the dirty work. This time he hits pay dirt himself. Chad Young ties up the game for Fresno State, 28-28.
Well, Sunday, 10 a.m. on ESPN, NFL Countdown presented by IBM gets you all the latest news, updates from around the league. Plus, this week, Ray Lewis interviews his old defensive coordinator, Jets head coach Rex Ryan. That should be good TV at 11 a.m. on ESPN2. Then you get Fantasy Football Now, latest news, injury reports, and predictions for the top fantasy performers. What a game here tonight at Qualcomm in San Diego. The Aztecs, I think it's safe to say they use their bye week well. We've seen new stuff on defense, new stuff on offense, and they are tied with the 17th-ranked Fresno State Bulldogs. The touchback will give the Bulldogs the ball at the 25. The fourth quarter has been particularly wild, David.
Yeah, it's been exciting. The unpredictable, there it is, the turnover and return by Edirene again for Fresno State. Everyone thought the play was dead. He goes on to set up the score, and then San Diego State comes back on the tight end wing around, and now they retain possession of the ball. The perfect pooch onside kick, and then it's Chad Young that caps things off to tie up the score, 28-28. San Diego State is going nowhere.
So it was 14-7 Aztecs, then it was 28-14 Bulldogs. Now it's tied, 6:15 to go. And Derek Carr, with all the Bulldog dreams of an undefeated season, a BCS bowl berth, that's on the line. Waller, nice run across the 30, brought down from behind, but he gets 7 yards on first down for Fresno State. A lot of pressure on the fifth-year senior who doesn't often show it. It's Adams, left side, good tackle. Excellent tackle by King Holder, and Devontae Adams could not get the first down. It's third down.
Well, they're being so aggressive outside there, too. Attacking those slip screens and bubble screens. Challenging the wide receivers of Fresno State. Those guys are mixing it up out on the perimeter now.
Third and two, and a huge play. Carr, hands off, Waller left side, and he did not get it. Martez Waller stopped short, and that kid has played very, very well. Dontrell Anuoha with the tackle short of the first down.
Yeah, tackle for loss even. Look at the jerseys, look at the defense. Bow up on third down.
Well, Fresno State, they like to go for it on fourth down, but Tim DeRuiter just can't take that chance with that field position. The Aztecs force a three and out.
Wow, at the most opportune time, what a play by the San Diego State defense and Anuoha.
The punt and the return man, Tim Vizzi, who's had a big part of this comeback for the Aztecs, going to have a return here. Up the middle to the 30, 35, and tackled short of the 40-yard line. But Vizzi with a nice return there. Aztecs will have good field position. The BCS standings, Fresno State slotted right in there in the 17th spot. And remember, from the Mountain West Conference, a team that finishes in the top 16 ahead of an automatic qualifier gets an automatic berth to a BCS bowl. If you finish in the top 12, it doesn't matter who else is ranked anywhere, you get that automatic berth. Fresno State thinks that's very, very possible, but tonight all that is on the line.
That's right. Northern Illinois wins. They're lurking around there too in that position along with Fresno State.
Aztecs have the ball back. Muema with the carry up the middle. He's been very strong in the second half. Adam Muema out toward the 45-yard line. I think it's worth repeating. If you're a non-automatic qualifying school, champion of the Mountain West, for instance, you get the automatic berth. If you're ranked in the top 12 of the final BCS standings or in the top 16 and ranked higher than an automatic qualifier conference champion, with Louisville losing, that seems like a distinct possibility if the Bulldogs can survive and stay undefeated.
And it's not just about getting there, too. If you get there and play one of those bowl games, what it means for your program and athletic department.
Muema power running to midfield. And the Bulldogs can't think about any of that right now. They got to think about this one here tonight because San Diego State tie game is on the move.
A little bit different type of game being played here right now. Very physical at the point of attack. Fresno State used to playing the spread teams, high scoring, high flying offense. Now they find themselves in a street fight, going punch for punch with San Diego State.
And I think Bob Toledo is feeling good about the rhythm the Aztecs have going on offense, and they're also being very deliberate. I think they would like for this to be the final drive of the game. Pitch play, Muema cuts it upfield. Muema makes a man miss inside the 45 and knocked down at the 42-yard line, a gain of 7.
And this is a distinct advantage pro-style teams or traditional offenses have over spread teams. When you have the game on the line, you have the ability to load up and grind out the football and end the game on your terms.
Now, the one thing we should say, the field goal kicking game for the Aztecs is very shaky. So you can't, if you're San Diego State, really play for a field goal here. That just has not worked for them. Ruffin in motion. Muema up the middle. Muema just that forward momentum even there. A first down and five, maybe six more yards.
And now you're starting to see that offensive line of San Diego State. Jordan Smith, Quigley, Gordon, Green, and Poole start to dominate this football game because they are attacking the heart of that Fresno State defense.
There's Seamus McMorrow warming up the place kicker. He has only attempted one field goal in his career. That came tonight. He is a new kicker tonight, and he missed that first attempt from 40 yards. Taylor under center. Hand off Muema, right side running, trying to pick his way forward, and still on his feet, nearly a horse collar style tackle. It'll be second down. I have to peel everybody off the pile. That's the fifth consecutive run play, and you said it, David, the run game, that is the game plan right now for the Aztecs.
Yeah, absolutely. They're bringing in the hammer, and Moema's doing the dirty work for him right now, along with that offensive line up front.
I mean, even there wasn't a whole lot there. He got 4 yards. He's over 100 for the game now with a couple of touchdowns. Might have been a little shaken up on that play, though. So they get the true freshman, a much different style runner, Donnell Pumphrey, in the game. Second and six. They'll give it to the fullback straight ahead. Power running from Chad Young. Still going short of the first down. Maybe 4 yards to set up another big third down play. Again in the spot of the field, David, where I just don't know that the Aztecs are really in field goal range.
I don't think they are for them, which is a little unusual and puts them at a disadvantage here. But it makes it a clear-cut decision. They're in four down territory. I think it gives them an advantage in terms of a play caller, Bob Toledo. No, he's got four downs to work with.
And Fresno State not using timeouts. The clock is running. We're down to a minute to go. Handoff, Pumphrey, and he gets tackled right near the mark. I think it's going to depend on the spot. This will be very big. We'll see if they stop the clock to look at it or just make a determination. I think they will stop the clock and take a look. They really had to get all the way to the 26-yard line, and I think clearly they are short. So it's fourth down, and now Rocky Long has to think about it.
And remember, this is Pumphrey, too, at only about 150 pounds. He lays it up there as hard as he can. But, boy, look at Deron Smith coming in there full speed.
A timeout, 44 seconds to go. I think they got the spot right in that he did not have a first down. I think they did not give him a very generous spot. I think they cost him about a half a yard there.
Yeah, looked a little bit closer than how it ended up.
I think they've done that consistently all game long. They have not been generous at all with where they've spotted the ball. That one should be a half yard closer to the first down. But Bob Toledo and company, no indication whatsoever of sending that guy out on the field. The place kicker, we'll see what they decide.
And remember, Rocky Long, Bob Toledo, they've had 16 days of game plan for this. And in their three-game winning streak, look, they averaged 5.3 yards a carry, 8 rushing TDs. They've been hammering the football, over 20 yards rushing their last 3 weeks before the bye week. So this has been coming. This has become their identity of pounding the rock and letting their quarterback make enough plays to help them win the football game.
The other issue for San Diego State, if they do go for it here, okay, you go for it, and I think that's what they're going to try to do, but there's only 47 seconds on the clock. We're showing that green line. We don't really know what field goal range is for the Aztecs. It's hard to know. They've got a kicker who's never made a field goal. So fourth and one. Muema back in the game. Muema has the first down and a yard or two extra. The clock will stop momentarily after the first down. 42 seconds to go, and now a Fresno State player is down. The Bulldogs defensive player is down and hurting. Now, there's a lot to process here because of the kicking situation for San Diego State. In a different scenario with a better, more reliable kicking game, well, I think we would know exactly what was happening here.
Yeah, and there's only 42 seconds left, and you're a running football team. You can't just pound your way into the end zone right now. You need some kind of chunk yardage.
So they do have all three of their timeouts, which is a big advantage. You can run the ball, you can throw over the middle, you can throw short,
yes,
and still stop the clock three different times. And at the very least, they could get into the middle of the field and try to give their inexperienced kicker a better shot at it. There's Seamus McMorrow, 0 for 1 tonight, 0 for 1 in his career.
Get as close to a PAT as you can. And
he's
right,
made
with three
those.
Timeouts left, exactly. That's when he'll get him some confidence there. But I tell you what, that's a big, tough run by Adam Moema. And who do they go right behind? Chad Young. They have an advantage in those short yardage situations that spread teams don't have. They're used to hammering it with the fullback and tight ends. They can play physical. And that was a physical 1.5, 2-yard run by San Diego State.
Now, Rocky Long, the head coach of the Aztecs, looking for a major win for his team. Trying to stay undefeated and right in the thick of the Mountain West Conference race, but trying to ruin the BCS dreams of the Bulldogs.
Rocky Long looks sly like a fox right there. When we met him the other day, he was telling us how good Fresno State is, and he's got a lot of respect for him. He's going, hey, look, we don't have these big guys. We got some tough, hardworking kids, and we're going to go after them, but we've had issues. And I'm sitting there going, all right, coach, but you guys are tough.
Deron Smith, who may be the best defensive player Fresno State has, very slow to get up. So if they lose him even for a play or two, he's got to come out for a play. That is not good for the Bulldogs.
Right, because he's their guy that they use pressuring the line of scrimmage, a safety blitzer attacking the line of scrimmage in this scheme. He's a big part of what they do because he's a physical player at that third level of the defense.
And from the look of it, I don't think he's missing just one play. We'll see. Deron Smith, who preseason was the Mountain West Defensive Player of the Year, was a big-time playmaker last year, has continued that this season.
Yeah, 6 interceptions last year, 3 coming into this season. Pass breakups, a couple of sacks, tackles for a loss. That tells you how they use their safeties in this scheme. They're attacking the line of scrimmage.
But again, 17th ranked in the BCS standings, undefeated. Fresno State, perhaps their biggest hurdle left before the Mountain West Conference championship game. Certainly looked that way coming in on paper, and it has turned out that way. San Diego State in position with 42 seconds to go. First down, and the ball is inside the Bulldogs' 25-yard line.
And remember, San Diego State showed us some trickeration earlier, too. A little hook and ladder off the bubble screen, you know, off the slip screen. A tight end around.
The power formation, Moema cuts it middle. Moema to the 20, still on his feet, inside the 20, down to the 18, and getting closer to the spot on the field, David, where I think they would be comfortable kicking the ball. That's a 6-yard run.
No trickeration there. That's just a good old-fashioned power play. Pull the backside guard, kick out the fullback, and attack the defense.
Timeout, San Diego State.
So another timeout. This time the Aztecs take their first, and very key that they've kept those timeouts for this situation. So a chance to think about it and get some strategy lined up with 22 seconds to go. While we have a moment, we do want to remind you once again, only 4 races left in the chase for the Sprint Cup. Hitting the home stretch, Jimmy Johnson and Matt Kenseth lead the Chase Field into historic Martinsville Speedway. NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Martinsville, Sunday, 1 Eastern on ESPN. Now here is Seamus McMorrow, who's a great kickoff specialist. But Wes Fear was not kicking the ball well, their regular place kicker. They made the switch during the bye week. He has never made a field goal in his college career, and the game could come down to his right leg.
And no time like the present, too. Be interesting to see what San Diego State decides to do. Looks like they're just going to position the ball to win the football game.
Kaler's coming to the middle, and he'll take a knee, then gets hit after the play at about the 19-yard line. Fresno State not burning timeouts. Now Tim DeRuiter decides to do that. So he calls a timeout with 12 seconds to go. So if they kick from this spot, it's a 36-yard field goal try. And after centering the ball, you would think that may well be the plan. They do have 12 seconds to go, though. So I wonder if Rocky Long will decide to run another play.
I like the idea of trying to gain some yardage to get even closer for your kicker on second down instead of just conceding 0 yards.
So Rocky Long talking things over. Mountain West Conference standings. Bulldogs, who have ideas of something even bigger than just a conference championship, undefeated overall. San Diego State, rough start to the year. They've turned things around. They're still undefeated. They would be in the driver's seat for the conference title in the regular season, at least in their division, if they win this game.
Think about what this team's been through, 0-3 to 3-0, and a chance to put away the number 17 team in the BCS.
So Kaler will take a knee, this time at about the 20, so 36, 37-yard field goal try coming up. It will be the final play of regulation. There's the timeout, 3 seconds to go, and go get him, Seamus McMorrow.
No time like the present, young man.
Pretty remarkable. And the Aztecs, a thumbs up from Seamus. Aztecs, who decided to make the change during the bye week. So while we have this timeout, another quick check along the sideline with Allison Williams.
This is certainly a new situation for Seamus McMorrow, but he's visualized this before. The very last thing they did in Thursday's practice was practice centering the ball, bringing the field goal kicking team on to practice kicking that winning field goal. They know the issues they've had. This was the very last thing they practiced on Thursday.
Sophomore from right here in San Diego, St. Augustine High School, has a chance to be a hometown hero for the upset. 37 yards from very close to the middle of the field. And now a timeout for Tim DeRuiter, trying to ice the sophomore kicker. And in this instance, sometimes I wonder whether that has anything to do with it. In this instance, you have to think that it could make the kid think a little bit longer.
Yeah, and there's always a question of whether you let him try and get as close to snapping the ball so he gets one under his belt, or if he misses, does that affect his head or not? But you might as well burn that last time out, make him think about it a little bit longer. But you got to love the fact that Rocky Long, you know, went through that exercise with the team, because you want to try and simulate some pressure for your team, whether it's your team runs if he misses or whatever it is. Trying to simulate that type of situation is what coaches try to do during the week before a big game.
So here we go. He's never made a field goal in his San Diego State career. If he makes one here, the Aztecs win 37 yards. The hole, the kick on the way, and it was deflected and it falls up short. No good. Kick was blocked, and this game will go to overtime. Fresno State, for the moment, has survived. Amazing.
They are alive. We'll see how low the kick was. The snap was good. The hold was good. And look, we'll see who gets it. Number 89 with the vertical hand perfectly placed from Fresno State. Marcel Jensen, the tight end. He's the one of the tallest guys on the team, and he gets it.
And it did indeed, Coach Long, get blocked. And McMorrow can't believe it. He still has not made a kick now. He may well be leaned on in overtime, because that's where this game is going, and the kicker could be so, so huge in overtime. We've seen that over and over in college football. Today we've seen it.
That was not a low kick. That was just an outstanding block by a guy that's 6'6" and elevated at least 10, 11 feet almost above the rim, and hand perfectly placed in line with the ball.
Well, a block that may have kept the BCS dreams alive for Fresno State. They still have to win this game in overtime. The season started for the Bulldogs in overtime with a wild one at home against Rutgers. It ended up 52-51 Bulldogs when Rutgers went for two after scoring in overtime. And who knows? We'll see how this plays out, but the Aztecs may have to abandon the kicking game themselves. You get two overtimes before teams are compelled to go for two if they score touchdowns. In the first two overtime periods, you can go ahead and kick the extra point.
Boy, I tell you what, and maybe there's an advantage here for Fresno State, having played in these type of football games already twice this year. One to go down to the wire, high scoring. This one's turned out to be a little higher scoring than we thought.
Well, they have had close calls. They're undefeated, but it hasn't been smooth sailing at every moment. We mentioned the opener, August 29th, opening night of the entire college football season in overtime. Watson with the touchdown pass. Here's the two-point attempt. It was knocked down incomplete. Fresno State got the win. And then, of course, their signature win against Boise State on September 20th. Fourth down play. The ball knocked down. Boise State's hopes ended. And Derek Carr celebrated. How about tonight? Jensen coming from way behind with the basketball jump and the blocked shot. The blocked field goal for Marcel Jensen. If the kick had gone through, Aztecs win instead. 28-28 and headed to overtime.
And that ball looked like it was in line to go through the uprights. Hey,
wouldn't want it any other way. That's
awesome. Oh, good sportsmanship from Derek Carr. Some words. Matt Burhey, one of the captains for the Aztecs.
Your options are offense, defense, or which end of the field we're going to play on, okay? There's a different coin. Heads, tails, tails, heads. What's your call?
God made us with heads, not tails. Heads.
Heads. Fresno State has chosen heads. Tails. Fresno State. You can play offense, defense.
They want the ball. There it is. He said offense.
Well, there are all kinds of confusion. And Derek Carr is arguing. I think he's got an argument there. First of all, the referee, Kevin Maher, called the wrong team name.
Has elected to play defense. We'll play.
And I think that Burhey, he first said we want offense. Now you want defense first. If you win the toss, you have to select defense. And Tim DeRuiter's a little upset. His quarterback, I think, had an argument. Both teams have played overtime games. And the overtime rules, we'll start at the 25-yard line. Each team gets one possession until the winner is decided. No game clock, play clock only. You have to go for two-point conversions starting with the third overtime. The advantage of playing defense first is you know whether the opponent has gotten in the end zone or has just kicked a field goal.
That's
it impacts
right.
Your decision making when you get the ball.
Absolutely. A little bit of confusion there. All about Jerome Bettis, huh?
It was shades of that, and that was not handled well by the referee. And then
it was a little confusing by him. You're exactly right.
Well, he said the wrong team. Fresno State made the call. They called heads. It was tails. And the referee said Fresno State wins the toss. San Diego State looked confused, and then Burhey said, we want offense, which is not what
Vince,
you want.
We want Fresno State on offense.
Anyway, the Bulldogs will be on offense. Overtime for the 17th-ranked Fresno State undefeated Bulldogs.
Can the San Diego State defense continue to pressure and harass and cover this Fresno State offense?
That's the big question. First pass, penalty flag thrown. The pass is complete for 5 yards, but that one may be coming back. Penalties in overtime are just killers.
Absolutely. It looks like it might be some sort of chop block is what I'm thinking.
So that could be a major penalty.
Personal foul. Chop block. Offense number 73. 15-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Now there's Cody Wickman with another penalty. He had a big hold in regulation.
And you'll see him right there. See him engage the offensive guard. The tackle hits him over the top. The guard goes low on him. That's an illegal block. So that's for player safety.
Yeah, pretty easy call, too. Back at the 40, the Bulldogs. First and 25. That is still first down. You can get first downs, of course. Carr, with plenty of time, flushed out to the right. He's going to throw short. He's got Waller to the 30, to the 20. Waller to the 15 and tackled inside the 15. It's a first down. He got 27 yards on that pass play, Martez Waller.
The San Diego State defense has been tackling so well. That one hurts him.
Carr will throw a fade toward the end zone, and what a catch! Touchdown! Harper one-handed. An incredible play by Josh Harper. I'm sure they'll take a look.
Instead of the high fade and high point in the football, Derek Carr keeps it low. And look at Harper make the one-handed grab. Boy, it looks like he might have maintained possession. We'll have to see. He has to maintain control of the football. Does the ball make contact with the ground? It is hard to see. Rule to catch and touchdown on the field.
The previous play is under further review.
Well, that's what's going to be a tough one.
A catch and a touchdown.
It may have touched the ground there. Well, we'll see. And from that angle, it's very hard to tell. From the first angle, what you were talking about, and we'll see if from this side we can see it. And I think it's the other side angle where we're going to have our best look. Josh Harper.
And he maintains control of that football through the catch. We'll see if the ball ever makes contact with the ground. His arm is underneath it.
I don't know. From that angle, I don't think you could overturn it.
And remember, that has to be indisputable video evidence.
Yeah.
Boy, it looks like it might have touched the ground there. But I think he maintains control of the football throughout the catch.
Yeah, so that's the angle, I think, where you see the ball perhaps hit the ground. Is that
and
enough to overturn it?
It does move.
Yeah. And see, that angle I just don't think tells us anything. That previous angle, I think, is our best look at the play. And he does maintain possession, so that helps you understand that part of it.
The ground cannot aid in the catch of the football, though. That's a tough one right there. You'll see it. Looks like the ball hits. Boy, that angle's tough. That's tough to call. I don't know if that's something they can overturn.
This is a spectacular effort. I think this is the one where if it does hit, you can see it hit right there. And it did. It moved a little bit, but whether that's enough to overturn the call, I don't know.
And you see J.J. Whitaker looking up as if he's expecting the fade and the high throw when the ball is low and out in front of Josh Harper.
Now they're taking their time. Obviously, it's a big ruling. We're in overtime. That touchdown puts Fresno State ahead. They get the ball first, and they've gotten in the end zone as ruled on the field. After they blocked a 37-yard field goal try on the last play of regulation that would have won it for San Diego State.
Looks like the ball touches the ground and actually moves. This is a tough call.
I think when it's this tough, you have a hard time.
Yeah, because of what you got to remember what it's ruled on the field.
Yeah. Now still waiting for the ruling. Josh Harper, a junior from Stockton, California. Just a spectacular effort. That's the moment of truth right there.
Right there. You can see the ball touching the ground, and then he gets it back up on his chest.
Is that enough? I don't know, but I think it did. I think it did hit the ground.
And if it hits the ground and it moves, they have to rule it incomplete.
Yep. And I think right there you see some contact. Well, still looking at it upstairs. And this is the type of play where you do feel for the replay official. That is not easy.
There's a lot on the line right here.
And I think sometimes in college football, we do not handle these kind of plays particularly well. In this instance, tough. Now Harper's waiting. Rocky Long is waiting. Still on the field waiting for the ruling. 14-yard touchdown if it stands. Now there is the replay booth.
And remember, the replay officials are seeing the same shots that we're seeing.
Okay, at long last, I think we're going to find out what's going on here.
After further review, the ruling is an incomplete pass. The ball will be placed second down and 10 yards to go on the 14-yard line.
And you'll see right here is what the officials see. As the ball comes down, it's going to hit the ground there. Right there, you'll see it.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's a great job by our crew to get the shot.
Absolutely.
To show every angle. And I think the replay official ultimately makes the right call. Now, it doesn't mean that Fresno State's not going to score. It's second and 10 from the 14, but they're not in yet. First overtime and the first possession of overtime.
There's Davante Adams.
Waller with the carry on second and 10. So that's pretty conservative call. Third and 8 here. When you have the ball first, if you don't get that first down, there's a lot of pressure on the coach to go ahead and kick the field goal. So this becomes an enormous third and 8 play. They can get the first down. They don't have to get in the end zone.
And we'll see if they expect man pressure over here. They run some kind of rub route between these guys right there and see if they can bring a wide receiver clear and in the open.
Carr, a little pump fake and a shovel pass to Waller. He's got the first down, lunging for the goal line. He stopped just short. Man, what a nifty play for Fresno State. Martez Waller with the little shovel pass from Derek Carr. He'll get to the line very quickly, get set up, and hand the ball to Waller, and he is in. Touchdown. The quick tempo, they punch it in from a half a yard out, and Fresno State does indeed get the touchdown here in overtime.
What a time to throw it. A little flip to your running back. Again, as all attention goes out to the wide receivers, you think where they're going to throw the football, and they take you by surprise right there.
Now that was a great call.
That was.
Here comes the extra point. High snap, but a good hole. Those extra points critical in overtime. 35-28, San Diego State's going to get the ball. Here's a look at the shovel pass.
You'll see it right there as the rushers go up the field. Waller heading straight north and south. And now he's going to get the call again. And they just hammer it home.
Well, and the pass play was really the key because it was third down. If they don't get the first down there, forget about getting in the end zone. I think they have to kick the field goal. So third and 8, the little shovel pass worked. I think the last thing that the Aztecs thought was coming.
Yeah, great call by offensive coordinator Dave Schramm. Again, how do you run the football in that offense? Again, it's bubble outside, it's a flip inside, draws, and he catches San Diego State up the field, and they get the seam for the first down.
Coming up next, college football final presented by AT&T. Aztecs have the ball. Adam Oema, nice hole up the middle. San Diego State's offense, until the blocked field goal at the end of regulation, they had their way up front, so we'll see if that continues in overtime. And the Aztecs' advantage of having the ball second is they know it's four down territory. They have to punch it in.
Yep, and I think that gives you an advantage as a play call. You know, you have four downs to make the first down. Opens up your playbook a little.
A good start, 6 yards on that first down carry. Boema still in the backfield, the fullback Chad Young. Boema gets the handoff, trying to bounce it right, and he is gang tackled and maybe pushed back for a loss of a yard. A guy who's been such a big playmaker, Edirne, who had the long fumble return for a touchdown. That was a huge play. He brought Moema down.
And again, they'll bring zone pressure up the middle. There's nowhere for Moema to go with the football. Tries to bounce it outside. Loses yards.
Well, the Aztecs, last 20 times they've snapped the ball on offense, they've run it 19 times. You'd think here they may have to put it in the air. Third and 6. Taylor throws short. The pass is caught. Moema trying to dance his way forward. He'll be stopped. Fourth down coming up. The game is on the line. A one play for the Aztecs. They don't have to get in the end zone, of course. The block field goal by Jensen. That allowed the Bulldogs to survive here to overtime. One play away on defense from winning it. And the Aztecs, they need about 5 yards.
Every time they need the play, they've gone to roughing right there.
We'll see if they do that again. Quinn Kaler looking middle with plenty of time. Throws toward the end zone. Tipped up and incomplete. And Fresno State has survived. Deron Smith, who was hurt earlier, back in the game, makes the play to win the game. The Bulldogs stay undefeated. Their BCS hopes are alive. Fresno State 7-0, 35-28 in overtime.
What a game. We have seen it all. The receiver open, but Deron Smith comes back from being injured to make the game-winning play on fourth down.
Oh, what a game. And the final play, you're right, there was an opening there, but Smith saved it for the Bulldogs. And the disappointment for the Aztecs of that play coming up short of their chance to win it in regulation, and a field goal 37 yards blocked. The Bulldogs got the touchdown in this first overtime, and the Aztecs just could not get it done. So a heck of a play for the All-America candidate. Extreme disappointment for the Aztecs. What an effort. But Fresno State, they found a way to get it done, and those BCS and conference hopes are still alive.
Absolutely. Everything they've been working for week to week is still alive. BCS dreams are kicking.
From San Diego, our final score, Fresno State 35, Aztecs 28. For David Diaz and Fontaine, Allison Williams, Dave Fleming saying so long. Now we'll go to the studio. It's College Football Final.